Good morning, everybody. Welcome to this session on pumps operations and maintenance, which is being organized jointly by Thea New Consultancy and Bharatiya Vidyapeeth. This is being organized under the Campus to Corporate Initiative of TNC. We will start the session in about 10 minutes. Thank you for your patience.
The COT room, this is coming frequently to me, Anand.
We are taking care, we'll admit. You will always get it because you are the co-host.
COT room, this is coming frequently to me, Anand.
Where is the echo coming?
So much echo is coming, yeah.
You will always get it because you are the co-host.
Sheetal ma'am, you are live.
Okay. Good morning all, and warm welcome to the 2 days webinar on pump operation and maintenance. As we all know that being a mechanical engineer, pump is playing a very important role in industry, and to know about it, how it is functioning in the industry and how the maintenance is going to be carried on in the industry. Regarding that, we have kept this particular seminar because hardly we are getting in details regarding this operation and maintenance of the pump. So let's enjoy this 2 days webinar for this details out of pump. And to present this webinar, we have an eminent industry delegate, Dr. Payne. He is mechanical M.Tech in mechanical engineering and PhD in reliability and management, and has more than 37 years of experience across various types of industry, both India and abroad. Now, it will be very difficult for me to express Dr. Payne in a little bit words. So I am handing over to Mr. Anand Iyer, who is academic heads of Thea New Consultancy. And Mr. Anand Iyer is organizing this wonderful, fantastic webinar for us. Anand sir has already conducted many webinars for Bharatiya Vidyapeeth College of Engineering with his team of very experienced people, industry delegates. So thank you so much. Thank you very much, Dr. Payne sir and Anand Iyer sir. And I'm handing over to Mr. Anand Iyer. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you very much, Professor Sheetal Patel, for those kind words of introduction to all of us. It gives us immense pleasure to be once again to be of service to the Bharatiya Vidyapeeth College of Engineering, students of Bharatiya Vidyapeeth College of Engineering, and everyone who is joining live. I request all the participants to keep themselves on mute unless and until they want to speak up. So this will avoid the disturbances for the faculty as well as for the other speakers. So this program is being brought to you by Thea New Consultancy as a part of the Campus to Corporate Connect program. So under this program, we create a lot of technical sessions and personality development sessions, which will help the students to improve their employability. And that's the whole idea about these sessions. And specifically during this period of lockdown, when all the students are at home, we are taking this opportunity to reach out to you students with the best of the industry experts to come and explain to you the various aspects of the different kinds of technical subjects that you have learned in your curriculum, and to add to it the cream of the industry aspect to it. So today we have Dr. Tarapada Pine, who has already been introduced, who is a fantastic professional expert in the industry for more than 37 years. He is a PhD in reliability and maintenance. He is an M.Tech in mechanical engineering. Has worked in numerous organizations, both in India as well as abroad. He writes a lot of technical papers also in prominent magazines and prominent societies. So it's a pleasure to have Dr. Tarapada Pine in these for us today, who will be taking us through the fundamentals of pumps, operations, and maintenance. So with that note, I would like to hand over to Dr. Tarapada Pine. All the best, students, and I'm sure that you will love and enjoy these 2 days of sessions. Thank you very much, Pine sir.
Good morning, everybody. It is amazing to see around 200 have come today to listen to me. First of all, Madam Sital, I am Pine, P-O-I-N-E, Pine. I'm not Pain. I will not give you pain for 2 hours. So I'm Pine, P-O-I-N-E, Pine. So I'll be I'm good. If you are calling like pineapple, pine, that's the pronunciation. So whatever.
We are extremely sorry, sir, for that pronunciation.
I understand it's not your fault. Like this, I had to listen number of times in corporate also.
Oh, we are extremely sorry, sir.
No problem. Extremely sorry. So just to lighter note. Okay. This is a program of a very important assets in industry. And this asset is handled by a number of specializations like motor, pumps, associated instrumentations in the pump. So it will be useful who were in other branches also besides mechanical. And in respect of your degree level, it is always good. That is the reason. And since you have a good interaction last few weeks on the different subjects by our colleagues, I think you are much aware of our industry input to the students, how we're going. Some students or maybe some experienced persons already much ahead of my knowledge, whatever I know till it, and I'm always open to discussion and taking the right concept to the students so they are in future, they are not taking something wrong way on any fluid mechanics related topics, exclusively fine handling pump. So that is the idea. So instead of going now, let me start around this time now. So welcome again. Objective is this program, as you know, we are going to have a conceptual and thinking of pumps, how it looks at our industrial application, and common failure more generally occur in pumps, and what are the, if failures occur, then what are the maintenance techniques you will employ so that pumps come into the restored position again in the industry. How is select pump when you are selecting a pump for the industry for a particular purpose, that also will help in this regard. Then we're talking pump everywhere, you know, we not in single sectors, industry or social life, while you don't use pump in different form and different application. So this will help. And more you are in structure program in campus. And the structure programs carries all the theoretical inputs, whatever scientists and management gurus have given to us, we are just trying to learn in the campus. Besides this, what is happening in the industry, it is better to have some knowledge on those. So that is the area, that is the thinking, that this industry inclined inputs are given in these two sessions. I won't go much about theory, but something on more on practical oriented, but conceptually should be correct. That is the idea. So that is all about our objective here. So the idea is to only to have in our campus to corporate a lot of disturbance, waiting rooms, classes. So that is the idea. Let us go to the session. How the sessions are planned? Sessions are planned this way. We'll have introduction. We'll have types of pumps, different types of pumps available right now. And what is the evolution of these pumps over the times in history. Then we'll have, once something is operating, it should have an operating parameters and how those parameters relate to each other. Those are the things required to be known. And in pumps, it is called performance curve. So we'll come to know something on that. Everything controlled by certain physical laws, whether it is fluid mechanics and physics exclusively or chemical process anything, so we try to understand what this the affinity about this parameters relationship. And when you purchase a palm, that palm will work in particular system or not, so understanding the system card. And description certain, because centrifugal pumps are used in a big way in industry, so that's why you will describe more on centrifugal pump. Okay, then different type of pumps and gear pumps and all these things we'll discuss today. Then cavitation and PCH other concept, and a VFD energy saving, how it helps in industry, we'll discuss tomorrow. And associated maintenance and waste maintenance practices, so that these pumps can be monitored and analyzed properly before it fails. So that is the idea of this session plan. So it is all about a overview, and it is not the complete discourse of the pump. Please remember, whoever is doing research or any other high level PG course or anything. So I'm not going to discuss what is the velocity diagram in the input and output, how they work out, what is the deviation of different working working for different type of pumps, efficiency done, then head loss, all this calculation is not out of, is actually out of this scope.
Okay.
So this is not a complete
discourse.
The background noise.
So
let's be in the flow. Let's be in the flow. In this flow, like to have your opinion on this. Like to have your understanding on the palm. So let's have. Anand.
So I will launch a poll, students, here for you to be understanding. Pain sir, slide number though, for this slide we don't have a poll.
Okay, take it, this slide now, first poll, ice breaking poll, just to have an understanding of the participant, what they think about palm. I think YouTube also there, so YouTube person can see the screen now.
Pain sir,
yeah,
for the first slide we don't have a poll, we just a question and answer.
Yes, that's the question and answer only, no? This, okay. This is ice-breaking poll, no? Let's be in the flow. If it's not there, okay, go ahead with this. Can you see my screen?
Yeah.
Okay. Need of supply of energy to fluid. Devices are, which are the devices? How do you supply energy to fluid? Can so anyone tell?
Unmute yourself and answer the questions, okay? Students, you can unmute yourself and answer the questions.
Pumps, compressors, and blowers. Yes. All
except C, correct.
Yes.
We get energy from turbine, but not from the other devices. That is the fundamental. To enable pumping system to be active, pressure at pump inlet should always be higher than the sump pressure. This statement is correct or wrong? Incorrect. Pressure at pump inlet should always be higher than the sump pressure.
False.
Correct. It should be always less. Otherwise, pump, आपको impeller में आएगा ही नहीं, ठीक है ना? So that is the idea. Positive displacement pumps are generally less efficient than centrifugal pumps. Correct or not?
False.
Great student. Like to hear that. Components of a centrifugal, because positive displacement more efficient, but having heavy maintenance cost compared to centrifugal pumps. Those centrifugal pumps are used widely in the industry. We'll come to know all those things later on. Components of a centrifugal pump are
casting, bearing, impeller,
ABC,
and coupling. X.
First option.
Casting, bearing, and impeller. ABC.
Casting, bearing, and impeller.
Impeller.
And shaft is not the pump.
Shaft is also.
Except D. Please unmute whoever there is a noise at background, please. Okay, so I'll accept coupling is not
third
a
option.
Use coupling for the pump. We required to drive it, you know. So it is not the pump component. That's all about, see, what do you think? Good that many have answered correctly. So, okay. I'm too much disturbed in the waiting room. I have to go. Then I can click my to the next one. Okay. So today introduction. Why engineering student need to know, this is interdisciplinary subject. Pump is versatile all over the world. Industry everywhere it is used. Low flow, higher flow, high pressure, low pressure, and different form. Demanding assets because it is very common in special applications. Dominant killers in maintenance because if you go to any industry, our maintenance ho raha hai. Kahan pe ho raha hai? Dekhiye jaake maximum jagah mein turbine mein, pump mein. रोटेटिंग इक्विपमेंट में मैक्सिमम जगह में पंप में हो रहा है तो इट डोमिनेंट किलर्स इन मेंटेनेंस ससेप्टेबल टू री इंजीनियरिंग कोई भी री इंजीनियरिंग कॉन्सेप्ट और री इंजीनियरिंग होना है कोई भी मशीन में यू विल फील देयर इज ऑलवेज पॉसिबिलिटी इन इजियर वे टू हैव री इंजीनियर द पंप फॉर द हायर फ्लो और द लोअर फ्लो और द हेड पीपल आर डूइंग लॉट ऑफ री इंजीनियरिंग इन दिस इजी थिंग्स आर अवेलेबल टेक्नोलॉजी अवेलेबल engineering tools are available, softwares available, so people are need. So we need to study as an engineering student. Maintenance and pumps, I just told you that why it is required so much importance. Lot of study available in the pump. People are, a lot of development, R&D is going on in the pump. That's why you are getting from the nanotechnology, small pumps for ICU units of these ventilators, even small pumps. Even for your syringes, different type of medical application, all type of engineering and engineering R&D is going on the pump. That's why a lot of institutes are devoted to this. In fluid mechanics, they take a lot of research in this. So industry as well, and OEMs definitely, because they are entire manufacturing process, manufacturing product, everything depends on their R&D on pumps. Okay. So there are many special purpose pumps. We are very conscious now about energy saving. And if you go to any solar power plants, pumps or solar pumps, or maybe any irrigation pumps or anywhere energy efficient you need. Aerospace application, so much important, I believe. Aerospace, in your ISS, International Space Station, pumps, you cannot fail. You cannot avoid any of the failures in the pumps. Medical application, lifesavers, you know, in the patients, suppose the pumps fail, patient die in the ICU unit. So it's so important. We think about pump is simple a subject, maybe one or two topics in the subject given by university. It is simple. We finish it, give some exam and finish it. No, we are everywhere engulfed by pumps. That's why one of my friends somewhere a few days back, I think he told that all this you are learning in the industry, theory and all these things, you know, it's just for exam, you know, it is all the things people have learned. But conceptually, why it is required is more important to know. Once you have a conceptual input to the pumps, then you'll understand where you are working, why you are studying this, why you want to know this, why you want to lecture this, why you want to have pump conference. All the things you come to, you appreciate the idea. So that's why I take it as a big learning experience in that way, because everywhere you need pumps. So special purpose, special application, we are totally engulfed with the pumps. That's my point. So how amazing, designer will see pump in different way, okay? System designing, loss calculation, all. Space scientists will see a cheap thermal control, how liquid ammonia is flowing, and its life should be so much that 10-15 years it should run without failure. Ammonia is not, pump fails, you understand, life threatening for all the cosmonauts, you know, and it should pump the, and so much reliability had to be built into this pump. Okay, so maintenance engineer, as it is, we are very common about this part, But we are not very interested. Those are interested in other industries. They know what is the importance of the palm. Say in ISRO, suppose something happened in the palm, what will happen to the liquid fuel? So all the things. Firefighting, something happened in the firefighting and palm is not operating in your complex. Bus, we all die in the complex, nothing else. And you think, we tell motor is not running, pump is, somebody tell pump, somebody tell motor, somebody tell, no, motor kharap ho gaya, pump kharap ho gaya, conceptually we are wrong. When you talk as an engineer, you should tell what is kya kharap hua, to kya hua, technically should be correct. So that is the idea of the firefighting. Suppose you take a process engineer, he will tell in the process how the pump will be used for a corrosive fluids, for a toxic fluids. So chemical engineer, petrochemical, pump means it is a pump and mechanical and chemical industry, you know. Pump, I think both can fight to know, give me this subject to me, it is mine. Give me the subject to me, it is mine. They will fighting each other. If they are not fighting each other, they are not interested in the pump more. They are trying to have more knowledge on this because chemical industry, petrochemical industry, pump is the lifeline, you know. So that is the idea. Too much problem this admitting student. So energy engineer need to know that so much energy problems. So we need to have an energy efficient drive with pump. So his thinking is different. What I put this, and one cycle, one medical practitioner, he wanted to have small volume, it should give insulation to the body. Small volume, it should give air. Here in pumps, in actually in medical devices, breathing also, though it is putting air, but it is called pumps, you know, that will come to know. People are calling it pump. Here also in, see, I can't see my screen. Can you see the screen in the corner left? I can't see. You can see them fine. Yeah, yes, you can see them fine. Agriculturist, irrigation, too much problem in the water problem. So pump is so much important. My dear student, your scope is very, very wide. Such an interesting application of pump. Okay, so earlier you used to have a cycle pump. Both, we call it pump. Okay, but it is air actually. It is not actually pump. It is pump. But a pump and compressor has the similarity. We'll discuss later. Okay. So it's all about pump and fluid. Liquid one, another is gas, right? So this is all these interesting points. Interesting points in space to achieve thermal control. Liquid ammonia, 15 years. This pump should run, this pump, scanned pump should run 10, 15 years. So that's the application. This rocket fuel, this pushing the fuel and the fuel, coolant fuel, and it has to have two pumps, you can see. So this has to run so provide. That's our interest in learning the pumps. So in medical devices, all infusion pumps in ventilator. This is the ventilator pumps, medical device, syringe pump, all these things that require such a thing. Should be smaller volume, high accuracy. Okay, molar volume, large number of tests to be done for the patient in the pathological lab. So pump should give a major amount, a small amount. Can you imagine a sample, small amount, what can be? You cannot imagine such type of pumps required to be. So human life, heart. Our heart is made out of two pumps, right? Have you thought about it? It is not one pump, two pump, and can pump up to 30 liter per minute. 30 liter per minute. Okay, so that is your imaging. You can see how two pumps are working in pump. Two pumps simultaneously. Any of the pumps fails means we know the consequence. So that's why God has designed this pump, which is never stop. But we need to have a care for this. Okay, because we cannot create such pumps, but we need to create this. So pump is life. Okay, pump is life because in agriculture, everywhere you can see, pump is life. Pump everywhere, my dear. So what is pump then? Pump is this, pump is device, just move and transfer fluid from one location to another. Okay, that's why I need pump. Mechanical energy delivered by the electrical motor, or some cases in process industry, you'll find turbine driving the pump. Small turbine generating power, that power is used for the pump. Okay, driver may be different. Energy used to increase the pressure of the fluid to overcome friction and loss. Okay. Centrifugal pump, rotational energy into kinetic energy, and kinetic energy is generated due to centrifugal force acting on liquid. Okay. So this is the idea behind the centrifugal pump. Can you see centrifugal pump, centrifugal force acting on liquid due to rotation of the impeller inside. So ultimate energy conversion takes place in two place, impeller and casing, in case of centrifugal pump. So here in the pump and compressor, very fundamental, important to note is pump and compressor, we put energy to the fluid, right? We put energy to the fluid. And in turbine, we get energy from the fluid. That is the difference between pump and other device. Okay. So what is pump then? Energy transfer from one location to another. Okay. So we need a drive for that. And drive can be anything, either mechanically, electrical motor, or maybe turbine. Okay. Then why study pumps? We have told already common industry. Maintenance contributes a major portion of the budget. That's why we want to study pump. Okay. We want to study pump because huge energy consumption by the pumps. So saving, can you imagine 30% of the world's energy consumption goes to pumps. And 75% or more than pumps, maybe 90% or more, I think it is there some actual figure, are centrifugal pumps. Okay. So such a huge. And as an engineer, whether you are in R&D or you're maybe in industry, right pump for the right application, which will give right application means, jisme proper head and coil capacity dega. Theek hai na? So right type and for right application, that's why you want to study pumps. It is not for passing exam only. If needed, we can modify the existing pump also. And so on, we can put so many things while you study pumps. And reasons behind studying the pump is failure due to varying head and flow. If flow is varying or head is varying, you need to have, then that time pumps, there will be many failures of different parts of the pumps. And seals, bearing, more are prone to failure. So that's why pump parts are require maintenance. That's why you want to study pumps. Okay. When you study this, what is your job scope and interest in this? You see, market size in pump industry is around 20% per annum, it is increasing. Can you imagine 800 pump manufacturer, either manufacturing seal or impeller or summer parts or the whole part in India itself? Can you imagine? 1 million pumps per year, 100 countries you export pumps. Okay, we have a lot of scope. And market share of this agriculture and building services, 50% almost 50% market share. That's the scope of your job. Job may be your research, job may be your maintenance, job may be your selection, job may be your marketing of pumps, anything. Such a huge scope. 64%. And if you see these pumps, mostly centrifugal. Centrifugal is almost 95% contribute to agriculture and industries. Okay. So that is the scope. And global market is increasing at 4-5%. And it is around $70 billion. And this data is from the Indian Pump Manufacturers Association. And there are market players of very important, KSB, Ibarra, Sulja, Kirloskar, then Flowsab, there are plenty. This may be list of few pages. Okay. So history and evolution. When first pump evolved? First pump evolved in Egyptian time, 2000 BC and so. That time, this was not actually pump, but thought process was lifting fluid from one to place to another. So that was called sadup, a bucket tied to rod. Now also in India, we have number of places in Kerala, West Bengal, number of village area you can find people are using this. Okay. this type of things you people are using, or some places they are doing this. So there is a history behind all over the time. Then slowly, slowly, there is a lot of changes occurs in the invented different type of pump for different application. Then Bernoulli put the equation where you can found that pressure energy to velocity energy to pressure energy, the conversion possible, and in every stage of the pumping system, this is constant. Then things have become easier, and people have started in the 18th century or so, people have done different type of pumps they've designed. And here in after the invention of steam engine, also people started from reciprocating pumps. Already they have invented that time in around 18th century or so. Yeah. So in first ANSI chemical engineering pump, first Danko pumps, 1924. Like this, there is a big list. I don't know whether this will be, sorry. This is not visible, I think. I could not try to make it visible. So over the time, how the pump evolved from this type of pump, rotating to the latest number of application, even nano engineering also, so much small pumps. So this is all about little bit history about the pump. So let's recapitulate till now what you have learned. Another poll, Ram.
So Painsap, I am launching a poll now.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Please take 3 to 4 minutes to complete this. 3 to 4 or maximum 5 minutes.
So I've launched the poll. Students, there are a few questions on this poll. So please answer them. We will keep the poll on for a couple of minutes. And those who are on the YouTube can also see the questions on the screen.
YouTube can see my screen. Can you and anybody ask YouTube person how comfortable they are? They're getting the screen or not?
Yeah, they are. I am observing that also, Painsap. They are comfortable.
Okay. 30 seconds. Maybe 1 minute.
We are getting some responses. Let us give them another 15-20 seconds more.
I get very good response for the first one.
We're closing the poll in 10 seconds. When, sir, I'm ending the poll now.
Yeah. So yeah. Two main components.
I'll flash the results. Just hold on.
Yeah. First one.
Are you able to share the results? See the results now on the screen?
Yeah, I can see the result and it is fine. Yes, yes, correct. Impeller and casing. That expected life of cane pump used in aerospace around 15 years, right? Somebody has seen my screen correctly. And it is around 10 to 15 years, correct? So 15 years is generally given because you cannot have, we don't have chance to replacement there. So high reliability. So you must see, if you suppose somewhere places you have seen 10 years, not an issue or not a problem, but reply to the screen which has been already delivered till now. So that way it is 15 years, otherwise 10 years also person correct some extent. So about 60 for next is, next question, where is your next question?
Another used in ICU, you can scroll down.
Okay, scroll down. Okay, ICU, yeah, piston pump, very right. Because it will clear, yes, piston pump is right. Centrifugal, you cannot have much control on this. Piston pump, small volumes, better accuracy and all, very nano applications, the small pumps are used, piston pump, right? Agriculture is approximately, what is the approximate percentage? Yeah, 95%. 95% our agricultural pumps are all centrifugal. Go around in the villages, you can see anytime, anywhere. Go around Alibag side or anywhere in Pro, how people are using irrigation and what is the response. Centrifugal pumps could be approximately 95%. Okay, maybe somewhere, some places 80%, but it is all about agriculture and building services together. Okay, so all building services together, you get this. Okay, then idea of pumping water equivalent is this, it is called Sado, not Shroud. Yeah, correct, Sado, S-H-A-D-O, this first pump. Okay, great, great, thank you. Thank you. So let's go to the next one, pump classification. Next is pump classification. We classified pumps in mainly two groups. The one is dynamic energy positive displacement. Positive displacements, depending on the nature of movement of the pressure producing members. Okay. Another is accelerating of impeller. Okay. Accelerating of the fluid by the impeller. Okay. So that is done by the dynamic pumps, which are centrifugal pumps. So dynamic pumps, positive displacement. Again, positive displacements are reciprocating and rotary. Rotary can be lobe, gear, screw, vane, and all different. Screw, gear also internal, external, and centrifugal, also radial and others. Okay. So pump, wide range of application, based on the basic principle of operation, we call it dynamic and positive displacement. So positive displacement, flow creating, it is creating flow. Our intention of centrifugal pressure creating in the pump itself. So pressure creating and it is flow creating. Whatever fluid you take inside, pumps takes inside in the cavity, it pumps the same amount. So fluid volume per rotation, whatever coming. And here kinetic energy to pressure energy. And can you see the animation also, GIF files?
Yes.
Okay. So pressure develop depending on system characters, or this is also flow depends upon system characters. So flow and pH, all these system characteristics. Because here system characteristic depends on the losses more. Here in centrifugal, a lot of losses. Okay. That's why it is less efficient as it is called. But aisa nahi hai jo kaam nahi hoga. Uske bhi percentage hai and it is also used accordingly. That's why it is used so much heavily, because it is economical also. Whereas positive displacement is not economical. Basic differences. You can see in positive displacement, you get almost constant flow. Kabhi thoda zyada hoga, yahan pe flow. Kabhi thoda kam flow hoga, but almost pressure is almost constant. And when you apply this pump to a system resistance, that system resistance give you system curve. We'll discuss later on systems curves. So any system you apply, suppose you apply a pumping system in your any pumping system sitco, if you put positive displacement, it will give only single step of pressures and you can put positive displacement. But centrifugal pumps are everywhere, it will become economical. And for the system curve, loss also minimized by less bending, less area. Suppose there is a big road, we have to dig it and you take it turn away, so that way system curve is maintained. So there is a point here, duty point, operating point, which pump curve and system curve, where this cross is called operating point. We'll come in details in the next slides, few slides. Okay. So this is the basic difference, my friends. Then this is the positive displacement pump. Whatever coming in different form, positive displacement curve, it may be rotary, it can be reciprocating. See, the rotary, constant fluid of the same volume is going on. Okay, so that's why it is positive displacement. How it works, when a fixed volume cavity opens, fixed amount of trapped inside the cavity closes and fluid is squeezed through an outlet, direct force is applied to the contained fluid, reducing the volume. As the volume of the fluid inside the cavity is reduced, pressure also increased, allowing it to be forced against the high pressure in the pipe. So flow rate is related to speed of the moving parts. Okay, speed of the moving is controlled by the drive speed, unlike centrifugal. So in each cycle, the fluid pump is equal to the pivot points to be noted. Pump equal to the cavity, pulsating or periodic. Okay, highly viscous fluid you can pump. Okay, no problem. performance, because whatever coming, whether it's more dense fluid or lighter fluid, whatever coming in the cavity is pumped. Energy will be different, time may be different, but your flow pressure on that fluid will be the same. So that's the same, almost similarity. There is a, in, there is not the straight PQ curve. P means H, your head, pressure head. Sometimes it is called a H, head, and capacity, generally called Q. It is normal nomenclature, normal the way it is, these curves are identified or maybe named. Okay, so this is all about high pressure outlet. Very, very high pressure outlet. So in this pump, you need to have a pressure relief valve. Remember this. You need to have a pressure relief valve. Otherwise, this may burst also, the positive displacement pump. So you see, simple plunger type pumps, okay? Exact amount whatever required. This amount for medical application, can you see? You cannot put 1 liter inside, okay? Such a small amount ml, some ml has to be passed through this. Either nutrients, not only medicine, you need some nutrients to be put through the intravenous. Other system is not working. So intravenous, jo injection deta hai, injection nahi hai, wo pump hai, usme laga rakha hai pump, and plunger is putting every time. Insulin pump also like that. People are carrying along with the body itself. Okay, so this is the thing. So another way of this high pressure, another way of advantage putting here, compact size, very compact size. Any centrifugal pipe, आप देखना कहीं पे जाकर centrifugal इतना भारी है, इतना heavy है, वो जहाँ पे है तो मतलब इतना sturdy construction हो industry में आप जाके देखेंगे तो high volumetric efficiency, क्योंकि volume उतना loss होता ही नहीं है ना, तो efficiency कब आता है? जब कुछ कम होता है तब हम efficiency बोलते हैं ना, अब ज़्यादा होता है तो क्या है? Higher ratio बोलो ना, तो simple as an engineer we know that जब MP efficiency मतलब something कम है. तो यहाँ पे कम है एफिशिएंसी, मतलब यहाँ लॉसेस बहुत कम है, दैट्स व्हाई. सो हाई वॉल्यूमेट्रिक एफिशिएंसी, वॉल्यूम का एफिशिएंसी काफी हाई है. स्मॉल चेंजेस इन एफिशिएंसी थ्रू आउट द डिजाइन प्रेशर रेंज, जो आपने जिसके लिए आप चाहे उस पंप को, कैन ऑपरेट ओवर ए वाइड रेंज करेक्ट एंड स्पीड रेंजेस. यू कैन पुट इट डिफरेंट वे, यू कैन पुट इट. सो दिस इज द हाई, बट सेंट्रिफ्यूगल पंप विस्कोसिटी इज वेरी लेस, आइदर वाटर और स्मॉल लिक्विड, स्मॉल less viscous fluids are pumped. Okay, maximum capacity, very high flow in centrifugal pumps. Okay, in centrifugal, very high flow. Pumping efficiency, average, excellent. Excellent energy cost. Energy cost, excellent. It is average because more pumps are used. Okay, self priming possible. Here, not required, because it is already flooded with suction. Life cycle cost to be very important, which we will discuss maybe today or tomorrow. I don't know. Maybe tomorrow we will discuss life cycle cost. Pump purchase कर लिया, सस्ता में लेके आ गया, दो साल के बाद खत्म हो गया, क्या मतलब है? आज pump ले लिया, पांच साल तक चल रहा है, लेकिन every year maintenance cost is so high. That's why the concept life cycle costing for any asset important, life cycle costing. So very much important, that we will discuss a little bit tomorrow. What are the things goes into the costing calculation in the life cycle costing of the pumps. Positive displacement, another type, vane type. In the vane type, we have advantage of self-priming. Okay, can rise certain times for dry, kuch nahi hone wala, kuch time tak. High viscosity fluid can transfer, vane type pumps. Able to work in abrasive fluids. Okay, self-adjusting vanes. Okay, you can see vanes are moving in between depending on this. Once pump here, vanes are stretched, and here it is stretched back. So here pump fluid is coming and putting, just coming and passing, from one to passing, just passing. So that is all about the positive displacement pump. At disadvantage, pressure capability is less. Okay, you cannot high pressure ke liye nahi hoga, and you cannot increase also. Material limitations are there in these pumps. Lobe pump, lobe means same thing, but lobe types. There are two lobe type. You can see, lobe may be two lobes, three lobes configuration. All are, see here, lobe type. There are, to keep this lobe, there need two bearing both side. This lobe also two bearing both side. And between the lobes, gaps should not be eccentric. That is also a problem. So all the things taken care of in lobe pump, and input output, you get you can get for abrasive resistance too much. Okay, so that is not good. Stopping boss, jamming, all the things are problems. Pumping efficiency, non-pulsating flow, timing gears, master here. Without timing gear, what will happen? Both the lobe will be straight, but maybe like this. Then bus gaya pump. So there will be a damage to the palms once it is not properly inclined. And that's why by coupling with the driver, you couple properly, align properly one lobe. What about the other lobe? That's why in compressor, lobe type, screw compressor, lobe type, you need to have a timing gear, which keep the distance between the two lobes proper concentric, parallel, no eccentricity. So that is a timing gear. Okay, so this can pump 200 gallons per minute, steady pressure up to 150 psi, oil and gas application, drilling crude, treating water produced in the upstream of the oil and gas side. Okay. Features, external pump, but unlike external gear pumps also similar type, where gears are used, big gears. There in the gear pumps, you don't need timing gear. Lobes don't make contact here. There. So, timing gear is provided here, similar to external gear pumps. But unlike external gears, lobes don't make contact. External gears, lobes contact nahi hota hai. Here, lobes can contact. That's why I need a timing gear. That's my point. Clearance is so kept minimum. That's why it is so important to have a timing gear. Where strips are provided, some of the tip of the, this is the lobe. So lobe ko upar ek wear strip deta hai. Kharab hoga to wear strip ko kharab karega. Baad mein usko phir reclaim kar sakta hai. Matlab recondition kar sakte hai. So this is the things. How this pump works. This is two lobe. In the picture here, it is three lobe. Can be anything. Okay. And the advantages, self-priming, no metal-to-metal contact possible because of timing gear, high viscosity fluid can pump, and so on. You can see the screen. You can take a print. You can go to the internet also. You can get, or you can take a picture of this also. So gear type. In gear type, positive displacement pump gear, advantage, self-priming, non-pulsating, high temperature application possible in gear. And in the gear time, disadvantage also pressure. You cannot do as much as you can. No solids moving possible because it is gear one after another taking the fluid and taking out. Fluid taking out like that. Abrasion, high shear. Okay. So use it very much in petrochemical industry, crude oil, diesel and all this. And adhesive, paper industry, food industry, molasses, vegetables, all places you can use these pumps are being used. Internal gear pumps, internally gear. Okay, internally gear and in between the fluid is passing. Externally gear, just see one side coming, another is just taking the fluid and it is gears messing properly within the constant gap and with this constant it is passing the fluid. Okay, so that is the idea. So gear time and PD pumps, positive displacement pumps have positive displacement have volumetric efficiency, which is actual rate value flow by theoretical flow. And in this, piston pumps are the more efficient volumetric. That's why it is used in small quantity in piston pumps being efficient more in medical application and all. Mechanical efficiency 90-95%. Okay. Efficiency, not the cost. Okay. So that is the idea. So let us recapitulate this pump section now once again. Anand.
Sir, I am posting the next poll, slide number 28. Are you able to see the poll?
Yes. Yeah, thank you. Yes, we can see it.
Thank you. Fine, sir, there was a question in between while this poll is being taken. The question was from student Saurabh Shivaji Patil, who is asking, can't we pump high viscous fluid by centrifugal pumps?
No. There is a limit up to 500 CST is given there. Okay, we cannot pump. That's why it is positive reciprocating pumps are used, you know. You can pump it, but you know other things you have to do. When it will fail, you don't know, next week may fail. Okay, I think it is clear. The answer is given.
Thank you.
Please go. Yeah.
So the poll is on, and we will. There are just about 5-6 questions. So we will keep the poll on for about another 60 seconds. Last 30 seconds, students. Another 10 seconds before I close the poll. When sir, I'm close the polling now.
Great.
Let me share the results.
Yeah.
Yeah. The results are on your screen, Pain sir.
Okay. So number one is not about true and false, right?
Yeah, Pain sir.
Based on the operating principle, the palms are of two types, and positive displacements palms are of two types. Okay. So 2 and 2, B is the answer. So what is true and false? Have you given what is this?
Is it no, same thing? Sir, question number 1 is appearing as question number 5 here.
Okay, number 1 is true. Suction number 1 is B, 2 and 2 pump, two types. Okay, suction pressure is always greater than the discharge pressure in centrifugal pump. It is false, correct? Okay, false. Then match the following pumps. Okay. Match the following palms. All are coming true and false. That's become a problem, I think, with the 1 minute. Yes. So match the following palms in this gear to displacement rotary. Diaphragm is displacement reciprocating, and centrifugal is dynamics. So which one is correct? You can search it. I think C.
Yes.
1. Okay. Anybody?
Yeah.
Yeah. So variable flow may be obtained from centrifugal pumps. Statement is true or false? Which one? I don't know. This is your poll results. The caller me here and there is going on.
Variable flow may be obtained by centrifugal pumps. 65% have said true.
Yes. Yes, very right. Then next is
the pressure relief valve is normally provided in the pump, in the centrifugal pumps or in the positive displacement pumps. 70% students are saying positive displacement pumps have the pressure relief valve.
I'm not able to match you in 1 minute. I'm just and too much disturbance with this waiting room. 1 minute. Yeah. There are 4 questions in this, am I right?
There are 6 questions in the poll, Pain sir.
Okay.
Are you able to see the polling screen?
Yeah, I can see.
Yeah. Yes.
Oh, you have increased the number of, I think, this one. Okay, fine. So, pressure relief valve is provided in pumps, centrifugal pumps or PD pumps.
Most of the students have answered as PD pumps.
Great. So this is all about. Now we'll go to the centrifugal pump then. Centrifugal pump is a very simple design. It's two main parts, as we told earlier, okay? And it is all about impeller and diffuser, two main parts. And liquid is drawn into pump through a suction nozzle, impeller I call, low pressure point in the pump. As fluid enters the eye, it moves towards the pump perimeter by centrifugal force, okay? The fluid is picked up by the impeller, so it collected by the impeller vanes, between the vanes, and accelerated direction of the acceleration in the direction of rotation, okay? As fluid is picked up by impeller vanes, accelerated in the direction, okay? So there is a spinning in very high speed spinning, very high velocity, and it releases this vane at a very high velocity. So once it goes to the impeller vane tip with high velocity, then what happens? Then casing is there, volute casing, which is also called diffuser. Okay, the liquid moves from the impeller to the volute casing, where energy is transferred to the pressure energy and is directed to the discharge pipe. This is all about. And as per the Bernoulli's principle, when flow velocity is accompanied always by increase in its pressure, when flow velocity reduces in volute, when velocity reduces, pressure increases. So this is all about simple thing about the centrifugal pump. Whether you study any book or any talk, anything, anywhere, it is same about this. Impeller accelerate karta velocity fluid ko, and fluid tips mein sabse jyada velocity ho jata hai. And once it is high velocity, volute designs are such that this high velocity becomes a low velocity over the time when passing the volute and become a high increase in pressure. So reduction in velocity in volute, right? Increase in velocity in the vanes. So this is all about the principle. See, in this is the discharge where impeller is rotating, taking the fluid, high velocity at the tip, and volute is designed in such a way with the increasing area will come to, because you know the continuity equation where area into volume, area into velocity is always constant. So one increases the other. So that's why this area volute casing is designed. So ultimate flow velocity reduced volute, giving us a desired pressure in the pump. That's why we put the pump, desired pressure. This is all about centrifugal pumps, how it works. Okay. And drive is given by the motor or any other drive. Dynamics pump generally used for low pressure, high volume application. Very high pressure, what you need displacement pump. Okay. But industry, again, there is always a selection. Industry will select as per the requirement. Very high, definitely positive displacement with low flow. When you need industry transport the fluids, whether hot fluid, hot fuel, or hot somewhere less viscous fluid, but we need high flow, we put centrifugal pumps. Industry use it, but it is not able to withstand any amount of high pressure. No, there is a limitation. There is a selection graph as per the API, NSI. I will study a little bit later. So it's all about centrifugal pump. Pump is primarily used for transferring fluid in pipelines. 75% installed pumps in industry are centrifugal. Okay. Out of the 75% of the industry, and if you take it with the building services and agriculture, this pump will be 95%. That we already discussed a few minutes back. Okay. So around 70, this idea have to how many? What is the population? Doesn't mean 80% if you put or somewhere, if you put, because people have different survey and different way, but it definitely not 30-40% or 50%. Okay, that's the idea. So classification of pumps, centrifugal itself, it classified what is the head, casing type, what type of casings, how many entrance of the suction fluid to the impeller, either one, two, how many? Design types of impellers. There are different type of design impellers. Okay. Stage. Suppose that's why a point has come. suppose you want to use hard centrifugal pump, but you need to increase the pressure. So we put number of stages. One stage pressure and with the fluid become a next stage, again it will go to the higher pressure, because centrifugal impeller doesn't know how much pressure you have given to the fluid. It has collected the fluid, it will spin as per the design of the impeller and throw to the volute. That's the purpose of centrifugal. So number of stages, you need high pressure purpose. Shape of the vanes, different vein blade jo hai, say vanes. Here you call vanes, in blower you call blades actually. Similarity, okay. Arrangement of sap, whether vertically you are putting the pump or horizontally or it is vertically. Okay, that is it. Arrangement of the pump. So here also radial flow, axial flow, mixed flow, and there are vertical flows separately. And based on shrouds, different shrouds means impeller, how it is closed, that closure itself shrouds, and the shrouds may be both side closed, semi open, one side not closed, and to completely open. Okay, suppose you take a grinder's blade as a palm blade, suppose it is open, so you can take it like that, those palms having open, it is just put inside the open impeller. Okay, open blade, 1, 2, 3 open blades impeller, and it takes, it just put inside the casing, it is open, no shroud, totally close the vanes. So that way it is classified, and in this classification centrifugal is generally most economical. Okay, now in palms we are talking about the fluid, so fluid is motion, that's why it is a mechanics also. So if it is mechanics, we know dynamics, how it is going on, and we know what are the principle about this, and you are studying definitely in your UGPG program, or if you are doing research, you are doing lot of calculation of energy putting. So in Bernoulli's equation also you are using definitely in fluid pressure, it is the fundamentals of the Bernoulli's equation. We not go to the very derivation because of the time frame and other thing, neither it is intended for this. Okay, so pressure energy, kinetic energy, and potential energy equal to constant, Bernoulli's principle. This is the Bernoulli's principle. At any cross section, you take this principle, this is constant always. That's the advantage for using our pumps. That's the advantage, we are able to use our centrifugal pumps properly. So this is the Bernoulli equation. This is the pressure head. This is the velocity head, potential head. Any books of fluid mechanics, you open it, you'll get it. So this is the point one. This is the point two at the discharge line, or it is input or output, you can say. And this is the continuity diagram. Continuity is velocity and D should be same, constant. This is the continuity. So the continuity, you can say, continuity area and volume. Excuse me. So continuity equation is mass in, mass out, and for liquid, same density liquid. So there is no rho in this, same density liquid. Otherwise, you have to take out different formula. Okay, area into speed remains constant. So that's the point in fluid mechanics, do use this. Okay, and here you can see volume is decreasing, increasing over the time. That means as area of this volume, cross sectional area is increasing. Here it is less in the input when the fluid is coming here. Okay, less, and there is a sequential increase in this, and area continued increase means velocity has to decrease. If this area is increasing, it has to decrease because multiplication constant, you know that. So why volume design? This is the fundamental. That's why you want to volume design like this. Otherwise, simple pump input output rakh do, और इम्पेलर लगा तो फ्लूइड प्रेशर इंक्रीज होगा नहीं. सो दैट इज द थिंग. सो दैट इज द बर्नौलीज इक्वेशन इज प्रेशर एनर्जी. विल स्टडी दिस व्हेन यू स्टडी एनपीसीएच कॉन्सेप्ट इन द लेटर ऑन. सेंट्रीफ्यूगल पंप्स टाइम्स यू कैन सी ऑल दिस बर्नौलीज इक्वेशन विल बी यू स्टडीड लिटिल बिट एट द लेटर ऑन अदर स्लाइड्स इन द मे बी टुमारो आल्सो. सेंट्रीफ्यूगल पंप टाइप्स एंड पार्ट्स. ओके. So depending on the different impeller stages, entrances, pumps are different. So in centrifugal pumps, impeller types are, this is totally complete, this route, the completely both side closed. So this is closed one. Okay. This is a one side open, both side open. So I tell you, there are three types: open, semi-open, complete closed. Number of stages also different. Single stage, this is multi-stage. You can see these are all impeller vanes. Okay, impellers, and there are number of stages in this boiler feed pumps. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 stages. So one stage input, one stage output, another stage input. So continuous pressure increase in 5 times. It is not time, but though a formula takes care, it will take care. So this is pressure is increased. Okay, so you can see components, different component. See, there is a coupling here, then there will be bearing, then this will be another casing, but for the both the bearing, it will be housed in a design like this, housed in the bearing housing. Both the bearing, some places design all are different. This is overhung. There is no bearing in this side because pump input is this side. You cannot have bearing here. So pump input this side and output this side. There are pumps where bearing in both side, but that time input and output has to be in the parallel only. Okay. So this is the impeller. This is the impeller, each impeller vane, the casing, discharge side, mechanical seal, which will seal the pump, seal the water coming out. There are different type of mechanical seals are available, different plan as per the API, the big subject in a mechanical seal. Okay, earlier you used to do some stopping boss, some gasket type of thing, stopping boss, very old one. Now in petrochemical, chemical industry, to different fluids, which is very costly and very very high temperature fluid, cannot come out, no seepage leakage possible. That will danger to the others working side by chain or operation people, or maybe danger to the environment also, society. So either mechanical seals operation is very, very critical. And there are specialists for seal itself. You know, there are specialists. They only take care of seals in the petrochemical, chemical industry. Okay. So radial, there are ball bearings, roller bearings are used. Okay. So here ball, the high load, high pressure and high load, high flow, you need roller bearing. Okay. Because it takes high radial load. So here it is radial. So this is radial. This is angular. Angular contact ball bearing. Those who have attended my bearing class, I think, I have not taken for you. I have taken for Francis Roderick's bearing class. So that bearing session, you have discussed in details. In the bearing session, see, this is ball bearing, angular contact. It can take some angular misalignment, and it will take care of thrust load some amount. That's why you are putting angular. So like this. So here it is more clearly is given. Motor is running. This is coupling. After this, we are studying here. This part we are studying here today. Other things are useful for driving this app, driving the impeller, coupling, different coupling, alignment, stator. All these problems are important to know, because once you not having proper drive, proper coupling, you will have problem in the pumps. Okay, the centrifugal pumps and components, it itself is this. Okay, and self-explanatory in the picture itself. So there are different type of casing possible, volute, vortex types. Okay, different diffuser ring. Here some places in the volute casing is designed such ways. Okay, pressure started from here itself. Okay, so casing, different casing. See here, different casing. So all here you have taken a complete equal area, but you have designed the diffusion in such a way it takes care of velocity drop. Okay, so this is the single both side. I was telling you both side pumps. See input out input large diameter input high pressure flow input input and output, and this is only single impeller. Both side bearings are there. This is overarm. Both bearings are in the same side. Okay, this is different component. Same way it is possible in vertical pumps also. This is a horizontal pump with number of stages, boiler feed pump. I told you that, and number of applications are available in the industry, different industry. Okay, so let us recap about the classification of and understanding of the fluid centrifugal pump. Anand.
Yes, sir. I am launching the pole number 3 for centrifugal pumps. Students, the pole is now launched. Fine, sir, can you advance the questions on the screen also so that...
I have already advanced. Let the other guys look into. I have already put in the... Okay. In centrifugal pumps, from the impeller to the pump volute, the velocity energy is converted to pressure energy.
Students, another 30 seconds before I close the poll.
Okay.
Another 10 seconds.
Sam, can you ask the Facebook pages, are they comfortable with the slides and the OA sequence is going on?
Fine, sir, I have ended the poll and I am sharing the results now.
Yeah, great. So in centrifugal pumps, impeller to volume, pump volume, velocity energy converted to pressure energy. Yes, very nice, true. Then centrifugal pump may be classified by working head, casing, number of stages, shaft arrangement. 1, 4, and 5. All of the above. Casing type, number of casing. Casing type matlab kis type ka volute ka different jo casing hai volute uska design different type ka hota. Working head, pressures, number of inlets. 1, 2 stages, number of shaft, vertical, horizontal. So all of the above is right answer. Okay. So you can see whatever you have responded, no problem. In centrifugal pump, volute casing is also named as diffuser. Also named as very right, correct, very nice, correct. Centrifugal pump is less economical than reciprocating pump. False. It is very economical, very right. Because reciprocating pump costly to maintain, that's the problem. It give high pressure with less flow. If you consider entire family of pumps all over the world, all over the manufacturers, all type of specifications, if you take it, then reciprocating pump is not economical, high cost in maintenance. Okay, so centrifugal pump is more economical. So who has written false is correct in this sense. Common types of impeller in centrifugal pump are all three, correct. All three, all of the above is the right answer. So 61%, great result. Okay, we'll go ahead next. Pump performance curve, very important. Please concentrate on this. For any pump engineer, irrespective of your level of degree and certifications you are doing, irrespective of your jobs you are involved in, irrespective of your future planning in a pump industry or so, or you are, suppose none of mechanical engineers is going to face, not going to face pump in their career. They have to face, okay, go to any industry. So it is very important to know performance card. Okay, in the performance card, nothing but the standard convention is given. Okay, standard convention is characteristic curve. This flow in the horizontal direction and head generated on the vertical axis. And at some time, all efficiency, power, and PSI also put on the card so that people understand what is happening to head with flow or capacity. And at that time, what is the efficiency of the pump is more important to know. And requirement, a pump, हम पम लगाया कोई मैसेज जगह में, ठीक है ना, कोई इंस्टॉलेशन में एक पम लगाया, कोई इंस्टॉलेशन में, कोई एप्लीकेशन में, ठीक है ना। तो इंस्टॉलेशन में पम लगाए किस लिए, फ्लो और हेड के लिए, तो हमको ऑटोमेटिक जाना है एफिशिएंसी कितना होगा उसमें, हमको एनर्जी कंजम्पशन कितना होगा, ये तो सिंपल बात है। एंड वो जो हम जहां पम लगा रहा है वो उसमें पानी है कि नहीं, लिक्विड है कि नहीं, ये तो कॉमन थिंकिंग फॉर एनीबॉडी। सो हाउ इट इज इंजीनियर, हाउ द इंजीनियर विल थिंक, एनीबॉडी कैन थिंक बट इंजीनियर कैन नॉट थिंक आउट ऑफ द बॉक्स, or engineer has to be scientific in his approach. So that is the idea. So different, this is head capacity. So more you increase the capacity you want to have, definitely you have to compromise with the head. Okay, so more you go to capacity, you have to, head will go down. So you have to get somewhere in between, somewhere. You cannot get the 100% head, 100% flow. No, nothing is possible. That's why all these efficiencies come into picture in our discussion, right? In our books, everywhere. No. So efficiency, there is a increasing efficiency, more flow, more head, but certain limit you can go like that. So efficiency goes down after certain flow. This horizontal is what? Flow. Horizontal side is flow. Okay. Same way, in net positive suction head. Inlet mein kitna प्रेशर होना चाहिए, दैट्स नेट पॉजिटिव सक्शन हेड, दैट प्रेशर आल्सो विल हैव एन रिक्वायरमेंट विल बी हाई एज यू गो अहेड विद द फ्लो। पावर, पावर डेफिनेटली इट विल गेट लेस फ्लो, लेस हेड, लेस पावर, कॉमन थिंकिंग। सो इन द पंप इट विल बी लाइक दिस, ओके। सो देयर विल बी, व्हाई पंपिंग इज अ प्रॉब्लम फॉर अस, why you in the reciprocating you are getting so much high efficiency, because frictionless, less friction, less dynamic, all those things less, that's why. In centrifugal you will face the pump piping friction. You might have studied in fluid mechanics piping loss, okay, 4 fl v² / d, I don't remember the formula, you can see this. So piping loss between the components, there is a frictional loss. In the impeller itself, inside also, there will be loss in bearings, other things. So there will be loss everywhere, and there will be loss in suction. There will be many things possible in centrifugal pump. So that's why internal loss, external loss. Internal loss, disc friction in impeller. Okay, recirculation sometime ho jata hai. So that is the thing, and external loss, piping, other thing. So in centrifugal pump, these are the two type of losses generally, two types. Remember, dynamic losses, two types, static and dynamic loss. Okay, dynamic loss, nothing but frictional loss. Okay, so when the fluid is pumped to the pipes, there will be losses in fittings. More length of the pipe, more loss. So when you think the pump distance from the outlet point where you want to put the destination point, if it is near, then your piping loss will be less. If it is more, piping loss will be more. But there should be a judgment on this. There will be judicious match for this, because if you take suction side longer also, then suction loss will be there. Pump pani lega hi nahi hai, ठीक है ना. There will be, there is a always judicious approach to this. Engineer look into this. So idea had if conceptually you are correcting or not, thinking you are correct or not, that is the important. Static head is simply the difference in height of the supply and distance given. कहाँ से कितना ऊपर में पानी ले जाना चाहिए, तो वो become a static head. And it become a characteristic of specific installation. कोई भी installation में जो एक एक फोर स्टोरी बिल्डिंग के लिए जो पंप चाहिए वो पंप हमारा 12 स्टोरी के लिए नहीं होगा. तो व्हाट इज द स्टैटिक हेड रिक्वायरमेंट, फुल स्टैटिक हेड, टोटल स्टैटिक हेड इज इंपॉर्टेंट टू नो. ओके, सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट स्टैटिक हेड एंड दिस इज गिवन हियर. ये गिवन हियर इन दिस इज सी हाई स्टैटिक हेड, यू कैन सी हाई स्टैटिक हेड, तो आपको फ्रिक्शनल लॉस स्टैटिक साइड फ्रिक्शनल लॉस इतना हो गया. And system curve will be like this, static head and friction end this much. So system with high static, system with high system high pipe loss, but pump ka samne hi wo aapko suction hai. So suction inlet is very not a problem, or pump itna acha hai, internal losses bhi bahut kam hai. To kya hoga, static head kam hai and static head will be very less, and it is be your suction will be available very easily nearby. Okay, static head. So static head, friction head curve will be like this. Okay, static high, that system friction but less near to the destination. The high near to the far from destination but near to the like this you can get it. Okay, so this is in all overall between these two fluid head. We get the static head. Okay, that is the thing from where to where you want to pump the water. Okay, if this water is bottom, then you have to take it somewhere down and bottom, and your head will be more. Okay, so this is the head loss and system curve. This is a called system curve. So in system curves, it doesn't come from the manufacturer or the pump manufacturer. Okay, or you cannot have the testing laboratory. When you put after the testing level, R&D, manufacturing, engineering हो गया, R&D हो गया, manufacture हो गया, उसके बाद वो pump को कहीं लगाना है, तो उस जगह में जो loss system है, वो system में भी different what you have done and has to be, it will be, because beforehand if you have given them full structure, जो कहाँ से कहाँ तक pump करना है, कहाँ से pump का water लेना है कितना दूर से, all things given to the designer, it will be easier, but for your specific purpose, manufacturers doesn't create their manufacturing facility, right? He has to serve all the manufacturers or different application. So system curve will be always different. The resistance will be different. So you have to match. Where the system curves and pump head come match is called operating point. We'll discuss little later. So this is about, there are few things to ponder on. Pressure head, pump will develop direct relationship to impeller diameter, higher diameter, higher diameter, number of impellers, higher diameter will be pressure high, flow also high, but there is a compromise in efficiency, we'll discuss later on. Number of impeller, size of impeller, shaft speed, pressure head, depends on. Capacity depends by exit width of the impeller. Impellers width, small, medium, large. So according to your flow out the output, flow is more, okay? So geometrical things, geometrical matter, flow is more, and flow is more, that is why your capacity Q is more. So accordingly, exit width, thickness of the impeller depends on, there is a direct relation on capacity, but head is not that. Okay, when higher size diameter is used, lower size, higher size, we'll discuss how specific speed is important there. Just have a relationship, because number of impellers, why you need it? Because you need high pressure. Okay, wherever you require high pressure, number of impellers, we have seen multi-stage pumps. Size of impeller important. Size of impeller, I. Impeller, why the water get inside the impeller, entry to the impeller, it is I call I. And shaft speed, more speed, less speed, more speed, more flow and capacity. But there is a efficiency factor in this. We'll discuss later on how it goes like that. Okay, so this is all about, see, capacity, if exit weight, see exit weight, suppose 1 inch, this is 2 inch curve, this is 2 inch curve, head This is head, this side flow. Head and flow card, which we call it characteristic card, which we call it HQ card, which we call it performance card, similarity, synonymous. We call it. So this curve, each, this curve is for 1 inch bit dimpler. Next one is 1.5 inch or so. And next one is 2 inch and 2.5, 2 inch more than that. You can see this curve, how it is going right side. Can you see that? Can you see that? The engineer can very, very simple to know. See, once you take high bit capacity, you are increasing. And how capacity increasing, you once you test in your laboratory, you can find it, capacity is increasing, you know, 10 times something or low. Or so capacity increasing, your curve is becoming flatter to the right side. Means you're giving, with the almost same head, we're getting more flow. That's the idea, capacity. Why it is not called head here? Because he almost same head. Okay. So the, I think fundamental is clear now.
Fine, sir. Fine, sir. One question from Shweta, student Shweta. She wants you to please repeat the previous slide, means two slides before. I think what she meant was the one before this, maybe. Shweta, if you are able to unmute yourself, maybe you can speak to Spencer also about what you want.
This one or this one?
Shweta, which one? Sir, system curve and head losses.
Yes.
Thank you, Shweta.
Forget about that. System curve, I'll come in details, don't worry. Same curve
will
carry on coming. Okay.
Yeah. Thank you.
Yeah, system curve will carry on coming. System curve, just I tell you, when you test a pump in a laboratory, and you can draw in your fluid mechanics laboratory, if you have pumps, head flow, draw the curve for particular impeller. You may not have choice of number of impellers in your laboratory, but particular speed also you can vary different way. So particular speed, you can have an HQ curve, right? This curve is your characteristic curve because you tested there for that pump. Okay. But if you put this pump, suppose you have developed this pump in your laboratory, in your R&D lab, this pump, if you put in practice in somewhere, there it will not, it has to face system curve. It has to, because there will be losses there. While pumping with the flow, head will also increase. With the head increase, flow also increase. With the flow, why you want to pump? Because we are experiencing resistance. And the resistance are two types, static and dynamic, frictional loss. So static loss, one is what is happening, what is there in the water, what is the level, that's all. Level is important there. In frictional, what is happening dynamically inside the pump and the pipes, or in and the associated valves and other equipments in the system. So it is system curve is a system curve itself a frictional curve, because this gives us an idea where I can put this pump. I have designed pump design for a particular HQ that will fit there or not. It will fit in the best point. If system curves and HQ curve meet in a point, we call it best efficiency point. Okay. Now, if you take the same system curve to another direction, your system curve will be different, not the original one. So pump is, one is in application there. Okay. There if we put our, there is application frictional losses will be different. That is the idea. So once we go into the different slides on different varying the different parameters of the pumps or different selection on thought, you will understand that. Okay, can I go ahead?
Yes, please, Spencer.
The head capacity are the main factor which affect the horsepower size of the motor to be used. Very nice. More motor quant to be pumped, more energy is required, definitely. And this is done. Already you have discussed this. So elements of pump curve. This is the head, this is Q. In the head Q curve, you can see the efficiency. We want the best efficiency curve. So this is the best efficiency point. And head curve, over the time your capacity is increasing, velocity is ahead also increasing, pressure energy increasing, and it will be in certain when flow is increasing, your head is decreasing, and that's why it is give you this card for this pump. Okay, for a particular diameter impeller, for a particular speed. Okay, for a particular diameter impeller and particular diameter speed. Now we have to play with this card now in different installation. So this is the efficiency over the time will go down. You cannot increase the Q. We can increase the Q, but you cannot get a efficient pump. Okay. Highly efficient pump you don't get. Highly efficient, if it is running here at this efficiency, that means head, if you meet this HQ curve, this is the best point for your operation. This is the best efficiency point where value of H, this value, and Q is the only value for that pump, where the pump will operate efficiently as per the designer efficiency of 80%, 90%, whatever is given. Got my point? Okay. So if you minimize, suppose if you diameter, if you decrease the diameter of the impeller and you want to see the same pump for the same application, same speed, I want to decrease the diameter. So this will, this HQ curve will shift to this side. That means you are not getting that much head or that much flow. Okay, so we want to do this flow. If you want the same flow here, like this, same flow, you have to compromise on head. Got my point? Compromise on head, much this much head, this much head you have to compromise. You cannot get. So this much head, you can get the flow. Okay, or and for this pump, for this diameter, you cannot get the flow at the lower, higher head. Okay, you have to get, increase the little bit diameter here so that it, this graph cut here. Okay, this much flow, matlab we want this much flow, this flow, this flow, this HQ cut, this one is not cutting anywhere. So by minimizing diameter, you have to compromise H value. Okay, for the same Q. Am I right? Any question? So specify duty point, best efficiency point. Okay, so that will be stable flow. This side, best efficiency. This is the efficiency curve. This only helps how I will fix my operating point for a particular machine. Okay, and the power also increases, but that almost remain constant powers here. You want more flow, but power requirement reduces. Okay, and accordingly, I don't know how the curve will go from here. Maybe some other here somewhere, and it will be impractical then. So main elements of pump curve is this. In different way I have put here, in different way, again you see. Explanation. Complete explanation of dynamic load, brake horsepower, NSPG, net positive suction head, and efficiency. See, this is the efficiency. Here, in this pump, best efficiency point is this point. Here, this point is the best efficiency point. Power is this much. NSPG is this much. Okay. Okay. NSPG, little increase, but almost constant. Okay. So, this is the different way getting this efficiency curve. I have put the different type of curve. Here it is more in the previous slides, more explained here. Minimum impeller and maximum impeller. If you want to have, this is the efficiency curve, and this is, these all three curves are HQ curve, performance curve, but in different diameter. Highest efficiency for this minimum, for this rated impeller, jo hum log kharid kiya, rated impeller suppose, is this. Is this point. If you, there is a always requirement of impeller diameter reduction, because you have purchased the, suppose you have purchased the, you have purchased the pump for an efficiency point of this, say 80% here, and head curve gives us a flow around, say, this point. This is the flow. This is the flow, and this is the edge somewhere here. For this, highest efficiency you're getting from this pump. But this flow is not required when you have purchased the pump. But this flow is not required when you see in the application. And you have no other choice. You have already purchased the pump. That time, you can trim the impeller. It's possible. There are experts available. Take out the impeller from the pump. Go to the shop and you trim the impeller. By reduction in impeller dia, because geometry will not be reduced. Remember, geometry of the blades will not be reduced. So geometry not reduced, it is not hampering our what? Hampering our not dynamic operation, but it will reduce the flow. You can see this card. It will reduce the flow to this. It will reduce this flow here. Your efficiency become a lower side. This was a high efficiency definitely. You have to compromise certain efficiency because you want 500 cubic meter per hour. Now you want 200 cubic meter per hour because of a requirement. And because of that requirement, you have compromised efficiency from this point to this point, lesser, and by reducing the diameter. If you increase the diameter, you will not be at all efficient here. Your efficient point will be nowhere in this car. In this pump will not be suitable at all. Because you can see, efficiency here in this pump, it is not increasing like this. You have purchased the pump, efficiency will go down like this. So you increase the diameter as much as you can. No. Even reduction also, you cannot go as much as you can. You can go 75-80% of the original impeller, you can reduce. You understand? If impeller dia is 1000, you can reduce up to 80% or so. Less than this, it will not be economical, neither it will obey your dynamics or affinities laws. So will be problem. So there is a reduction, there is a standard, 10 to 20% or so. So between 75, 80, 85, like that, exact, like that you have to take it. You cannot reduce the, either you have to go for a new pump, for the new thinking you are doing now. That is the idea. Okay, so efficiency pump, how it reflects is given. And accordingly, yes. And accordingly, BEP is valued like that. Are to be valued like that. BEP is to be valued like that. Okay. So this is the head. I think it is clear. Any doubt on this? I'll come to know from the responses and maybe in the when I recapitulate the session. So this is the pump curve that explains pump's efficiency, head curve, its reduction and increase, impeller dia increase. We'll learn also from the affinity law, what is the impact of variation of the speed. The same thing in given different way. Okay, we have already discussed. Same thing is given in different way. Okay. Different way. See how diameter changes your NPCH. This is your diameter changes and your BHP also requirement going down. You can see for the entire range of the pump. So that is a benefit. Okay. Head curve is all the head curve. You can see this dia, 10.88 dia. Head curve is from here, this one. Again, this one, this one, this one. So number of impeller dia taken together, manufacturers gives graph like this. The NPCH you can write anywhere, top or bottom, anywhere separately with this. Okay. That is not a big problem, this graph. Or BHP, you can write top, bottom, anywhere in the graph. That's not an issue. Okay. Efficiency curve is 79 efficiency. Then 79 efficiency, suppose this curve of this HQ curve. You want to decrease the diameter to 10.88 to 10.5. So you get this curve. Head capacity curve or performance curve, you get this. In this, Yukis, this car cut in 2 points. 79 to 78% efficiency. Okay. That means if your dia reduced, your efficiency point will be high in this 2 point. But depending on your requirement, what Q and pressure you require, you can choose this. Okay. So it is because there, just for explanation, we have taken only two carb and big way it is enlarged, zoomed, and we get the carb like this. Here is it is because number of impeller shown and so many efficiencies has to be shown, and higher NPCH and NPA to be in the same form, the dynamic, total dynamic head is shown here and total capacity is shown this side. So the different way you're looking into the graph. There is a tolerance. You can take 10 plus minus 10% tolerance of this graph. Head capacity also 10% when in manufacturing. You cannot take anything as per the head capacity curves. Suppose going out of this, we not manufacture that pump. We not use. Or somebody is asking for you, then you have to tell him, no, give me a separate diameter or other thing. I cannot give you head capacity. So there is a same pump you can use for plus minus 5% head capacity curve is maintaining like this. Or efficiency maintaining plus minus 10%. Or horsepower maintaining plus minus 8%, you can use this. So due to manufacturing tolerances, variances is possible in carbs. Okay, that is the idea of this tolerances. Now what is going on? The pump performance carb and reliability. How pumps, these are the pumps. We know the components of the pumps. We'll come to know in details also later on. These components of pumps will have always, nothing is reliable wholly, you know. You might have seen my lecture previously. Everything has to fail sometimes. That's why unreliability thoughts, these things have come, and so much calculation in ST and statistical data and all these things. Different distribution of failures are being studied seriously. So unreliability is there, and pump unreliability depend on, if it is excessive vibration, it will, because of, if it is exact efficiency point, pump will vibrate less. Because it is operating as per the requirement of H and Q. Okay. If it is out of DAS, left or right of BEP, best efficiency point is the operating point, then there will be vibration, and vibration causes, there are many other things, bearing, chemical, mechanical seal, shaft, impeller, all this. By vibration analysis, you can find out which is the part is the problem. NPCH imbalance, agar aapko jyada kam ho gaya, availability and requirement ke upar, next project suction head jo required hai and available hai, usme agar jo imbalance ho gaya, not required, to cavitation hoga, and cavitation ka details will discuss tomorrow. High temperature caused by suction, cavitation kab nahi hota hai, jab suction pressure at the inlet will never increase the vapor pressure of the fluid. That fluid, water. Some of the fluid, that fluid vapor pressure. And very important, this big problem in the centrifugal pumps, cavitation. So people, every time people talk about cavitation, all about the plant everywhere. A pump cavitated ho raha hai. Matlab kabhi vibration bhi ho raha hai. So all the things we'll discuss in the maintenance when you discuss there tomorrow. Okay. I have put so many things in one two-day session, but I don't know whether I'll be able to. Every time, as usual, pine is very having less time. So, pardon me. So, we'll try to do something on that. So, unreliability is a big factor problem in, and to have some certain to overcome this in certain extents, we can use VFD or throttling the pump by using control valves, different way. Either it be mechanically, personally standing there, maybe electronically, see digital nowadays, pump also being monitored or digitally nowadays, sensors are put, it is being digitally, vibration parameters put digitally over the cloud, and you can monitor the pump's bearing problem, cavitation problem, everything. There are separate teams of symptoms we will discuss in different forum. Okay, so these are the unreliability part, we can do it. In unreliability, we call it this pump best efficiency point. See, a reliability curve can continue increasing And after the best efficiency point is sudden, it carry on decreasing. And it looks like this. So best efficiency point is somewhere 80% to 110%. Why 80%, 10 plus minus or 20 plus minus, we can't tell. Can anybody tell? This is 80%. This is the reliability curve. We all know head curve right now. Okay. Head curve, low flow cavitation problem, if it's very low flow, lower impeller life, discharge circulation, low bearing seal life, all these things will come if it is cavitating. So lower flow side, high temperature, all this. But this is, suppose the pump is operating at best efficiency point. So this best efficiency point, why left side 80%, why right side is 110%? Because this flow is reducing over the time and it touches here only. It is not touching here. So we cannot take it here, this place. So that's why. But for the understanding, 80 to 110% is the efficiency tolerance, range you can take for the best efficiency point to have the pump with no problem of unreliability as such. It will operate in highest efficiency point. Anything like anything on high efficiency, whether your body or your car or anything, whichever high efficiency, it is taking care of all the parameters for which it is designed for. That's the point of efficiency. So here, main is 80 to 110% is the best efficiency recommended zone running the pumps. You can see up to here. This pump is more flatter, that's why it is not flatter here, steeper. So decreasing steep, so steeper, that's why it is here, 80 to 80%. I don't know, I can't see because of this sharing and number of participants. This screen is coming frequently over my screen. So whatever. So I'm very much less in handling computer by inefficiency. Okay, I'm not efficient in this. So pardon me for that. So whatever, head, coming to the discussion point, head and best efficiency point, right? Okay, so lowest vibration, can you see? Best efficiency point is the lowest vibration. If you take the vibration this side and this side is the flow and best over the time flow. Okay, so it is a flow, this flow and this point, this is the flow and this point you can find highest efficiency, lowest vibration. Lowest vibration, that means pump is running. So minimum vibration around BAP. That is the idea of knowing this curve. It is a relationship to unreliability. What are the unreliability coming factors coming into the pumps? All these things, you have some idea on this slide. Okay, so two pumps, if connected in series, what is going to happen? If you connect in series, efficiency curve, if you series, this is in parallel, series, two pumps, ek pump ka pani, dusra pump ka inlet mein gaya. Theek hai na? Is series connection. Dono pump simultaneously taking fluid from the same suction and putting in the same header. Both parallel. Now, what is happening to the HQ curve? You can see two pumps in series, what will happen? Pressure will increase, right? So your best efficiency point from this is the system curve. I told you system curve over the head will increase over the head or friction or encountering problem in the palm will increase over the flow is the system curve. And this system curve while connect with the performance curve becoming operating point. And that operating point is all of our consideration for our study, analysis, research, everything. Use, vibration, reliability, you take anything, okay. So that is the thing. So this is the system curves all about encountering the problem in the pump, and we encounter problem, and that's why you get rid of it and give some other energy to get rid out of this problem. And this problem is a system problem, and this problem is a system resistance, and this problem gives us a curve which looks like this head, okay. So, and we are not only problem creator, na? This pump is having some parameter which is being adjusted in its design. So that is HQ curve. So where it is best efficiency point? Where this problem will be get rid of. That means this is the point where it is connecting. That is all about fundamentals. So two pumps in series, yes. So it gives increasing pressure. Here it is increasing volume. More water will be flow, but pressure is constant. Remember these two points. Any number of pumps laga diya apne, kis liye lagana hai, sab thinking pehle karna hai. Theek hai na? So these people are thinking number of pumps in series like this. I think I have a photograph. Yes, you can see. This you are seeing 10-15. If you go to any steel plant or power plant or any petrochemical plant, lines of pumps up like this. Some are series, some are pump. Now in many places, people are putting less one pump for maintenance cost, and number of stages they are increasing. You know, this is the conceptual thought to be conveyed to you. That's why I put this slide. Now, if you earlier have studied. Diameter changes, what is happening? Here, diameter changes. If you change the diameter, we have discussed how if you change from 1500 to 1400, suppose, then these are all efficiency curve. Efficiency will go down from there to there, there. Do not take shape of the curve in mind. Take the concept in mind. Curves are given for presentation, for some application, and some application simply test lamp. Some application just drawn by somebody. Okay, so don't take all the curves, whatever you find in books, internet, anywhere. Take the concept in hand. Okay, so here, earlier one is very steeper curve in 1450. Don't take like that way. So these are ISO efficiency lines. 71% will become less in the lower diameter. We have checked that. Okay. So, and same curve, when you RPM is change, sorry, lower diameter is there. That also you have seen lower diameter. Here in RPM is changing, matlab N is changing, machine speed is changing. In that changing machine speed, you can see your HQ curve, H also changing, 400 to less than, say around 300 Q mein aa gaya, cubic meter per mein aa gaya, 300. This is, if this is 71%, which is 400 cubic meter per hour, it has become this one by changing the speed. That means speed variation important. Huh? You can increase the flow, decrease the flow, or increase the flow depending on the process. But you have to compromise efficiency. More efficiency, increase the flow, increase the speed, but everywhere there is a resistance पकड़ के रखेगा आपको दूसरा कोई पैरामीटर में, ठीक है ना? So वो देखने का है. So 1200 ये 1400 RPM का या, then 1450, then if you see some other RPM, then you may get our efficiency point out of the efficiency point. So you have to check all this thing. So here you can see system curve. Our system curve is this. This is the system curve where pump is installed. This system curve is giving efficiency point at this cutting the pump flow. Pump performance curve here. This is the performance curve of the system difficulty. Okay, yellow one. This is the blue one, performance curve we have purchased, pump. And this is the efficiency point. I'm repeating the same thing many times right now so that it click in your mind anytime. So suction pump, 86%. Speed, decrease the speed, it will go to this point. Go to this point like this. And you have to compromise the flow. But if you're compromising flow, is your desired flow, suppose 800-700 say leke aap usko aapko less than 600 mein chalana chahta hai because your process requirement is good. But my dear friend, you will have high vibration, maybe some other problem over the time. So if somebody is telling, no, we have changed the pump, flow is giving why, but everything is fine, process is fine. My dear friend, you have taken care of process things. What about what about mechanical things? So that time mechanical maintenance problem, they can increase more. So there will be a judicious thinking, a common table conference with maintenance of pump, mechanical, electrical, both, because motor is involved. I'll show you how much motor problem coming. I don't know whether I'll be able to do it today or not. And so motor all combined together, have a meeting and identify. Okay, by reducing the, should I purchase a new pump? Or should I go for diameter change? Or should I go for speed change? You have to take a very judicious decision for this, a concrete decision on this. And discussion should be all together, all the stakeholders, chemical plant, process. Chemical plant people are no. My friends here in somebody here, I don't know, don't take it other way. Chemical, there are process engineers. In steel plants, metallurgy are process engineer, operating engineer. There is always fight between the chemical and maintenance guys. So if you take it together, everything in a one platform, then you can tell, my dear friend, this system carb is like this. There everybody expert on this, maintenance and your process and electrical guy. All will be combined fighting together whole life then. So you take together, take the scientific things together in between the, on the plate and discuss which to eat. Okay, so that is the idea of this and idea of putting this. So I don't know whether I've told the things. So another way, static head in direct listen to fix. Okay, fixing it. Well, so idea is no compromise on ideal running. Ideal running compromise nahi karna. So aapko problem de rahe aapko pump mein. So and desire reduction should be PHQ. आप देखो आप क्या चाहते हैं डिजायर रिडक्शन आप पावर हेड एंड क्या क्या रिडक्शन चाहते हैं बट नो कॉम्प्रोमाइज आइडियल रनिंग कंडीशन वो कॉम्प्रोमाइज नहीं करना अगर वो करना है तो दीज आर द थिंग्स विल हैपन गोइंग टू हैपन दैट हैज टू बी टेकन केयर ऑफ बाय द पार्टी इकोनॉमिक बेनिफिट टू मच सी इकोनॉमिक बेनिफिट इफ यू फ्लो नो लॉन्गर इफ यू कैरी ऑन पुटिंग रिड्यूसिंग स्पीड एंड It will and system, but the speed is not good enough to take care of the static load, system carb, static load. So what will happen? Your system carb is looking like this now. Same pump you want to use, this pump. You want to use this system carb. What will happen? System carb will take this carb much higher, less frequency, less efficient. Flow no longer proportional to speed here. And flow no longer proportional to speed. That means it is so much inefficient is going and system car is going flatter. That's it. Static head is high. And that must be some economic benefit in this. Economic benefit compromising on ideal running. It's not, you are compromising. Okay. So in here you are compromising because your system car is increasing. And that's why you cannot take any speed whatever you feel like. Okay, so there is a speed compromisation and here is a static head when it is high, how the system is working is explained here. Okay, so here here must a system curve and note speed regulation is always more efficient than by control bar. Here by you are controlling the flow and flow you are reducing. Okay, flow you are reducing and you are getting very high less frequency. Okay, flow you are reducing, static high is high, flow reducing, static high you are increasing, dynamic load also increasing. So LTAR friction is increasing, so there is be economic benefits question mark. Okay, here speed reduction there is a good but there is again compromise for both the car. Idea, whatever you take, there is a compromise. Speed, either of this, you can do speed regulation is efficient than the control regulation. Okay, valve control by throttling. System carb increasing, you've seen the last one, how system carb is becoming stiffer or flatter like this. So pump controls by throttling. Throttling means you are reducing, you are in closing the valve. And valve closing around 30%, suppose. And you want, this is your main efficiency point of the pump curve and efficiency point. Once you throttle it, it will take the curve of the next blue one. And in that case, system curve, this 82% will go up. And accordingly, because system curve mein aapko close karne mein aapko friction bada raha hai, toh aapko a curve nahi milega, 82% wala curve nahi milega. So pump efficiency jab 82% here, pump efficiency 500 में जो था वो अब नहीं रहेगा. सो सिस्टम कार 300 क्यूबिक मीटर अगर आपको फ्लो चाहिए तो दिस विल यू हैव टू कॉम्प्रोमाइज विद द हेड. ओके, सो इन सिस्टम कार विद फुल ओपन कंडीशन इज दिस, हाफ ओपन कंडीशन इज दिस. ओके, एंड इन दैट प्रोसेस यू हैव टू कॉम्प्रोमाइज और यू हैव टू हैव एक्स्ट्रा हेड ऑफ 20 मीटर Okay, partially closed valve will have this. You want to same place, but you want the same flow, then your pump, this pump will not work. You have to take separate pump H2 car. Okay, so this is about throttling. By throttling, you have a problem of shifting of pump efficiency. And you have to work extra. Pump has to work extra. That's why it is less efficient. Okay. So how performance test is done in laboratory or any other car. Let us recapitulate this session. Pump. It's already 12. Can I take a few minutes more? Other I have to stop it here itself.
Yeah. So, Pain sir.
Yes, sir. You can continue. No problem.
Yeah.
Okay. So, I'll continue another 10-15 minutes. 15 minutes.
Yes, sir. Definitely.
Okay.
Thank you, Sheetal ma'am. Posted the next poll, students, which contains a few questions here. 5 of them. Can you please mark these questions and reply back?
Do I know how many are YouTube? Are there any?
Almost 35-40 participants are still there on YouTube, points up.
Okay. YouTube guys are seeing this screen or not? Just check some.
Yeah, they are seeing the screen.
Okay, good.
And sir, there are 52 participants and they're able to see your questions screen.
Oh, great, very nice. Sam, you are on YouTube?
Yeah, both, I mean, both Ananda and me are watching both.
Yeah.
Great. So, these simple questions are given just to change your, whether just to bring it in your mind and it keep in your mind and later on you could develop your study further. I told you it's not a big, I'm not going for any big calculation anywhere. It is the way how it is required for the industry. So, okay, good to have you. So, this is about pressure head cap delivered by pump manufacturer is known as.
So, Pain sir, I will hold the poll for another 15 seconds and then I will close it. Want to grab a glass of water, Pain sir?
Sorry, thank you for reminding me.
Students, let the answers come in. Another 15 seconds before I close the poll. There is an individual by the name QCOM BTD who has raised the hand. Is there any question that you want to ask?
Yeah.
Sir, I'm closing the poll.
Yeah.
And sharing the results now.
Yeah, great. So pressure head capacity deliver, okay, not the three system curve is not run by the manufacturer. Okay, they have may have knowledge, they supply with the pump head cube pump performance characteristic curve. In your laboratory also you can do both HQ and performance curve is synonymous. I told you to confuse you, I put two times. And system curve is the system resistance. Okay, that it is done in the application part. Okay, so manufacturers don't give. So system curve is the equation. But when you talk with the manufacturer for certain application, they will come to know. But in your all manuals, other things, you will get this. Okay, so that is the thing. One and two, both are correct. So pumping system is always a combination of two main head losses. Yes, very nice. Yes, two head losses dynamic. Great. Pump characteristic curve and system curve should meet at a point which is called best economic point, efficiency point, operating point. Great. Two is the right. Okay. So, capacity is determined as exit wind. Very nice. Very right. Because flow is the exit wind. I told you small, bigger, and larger. That larger width of the impeller, right? Okay, that is good. On attempt to reduce impeller diameter, BEP shift to right of the head cap, true or false? It is completely false. If your impeller reduced diameter, okay, that I've shown you, now, once you're reducing the diameter, minimum diameter, an efficiency curve, if you have not seen, you'll come to know some curve again. And you will understand that it shifts to the left. Okay. On attempt to reduce impeller diameter, reduce, not increase. Okay. So that is about, thank you for this response and time. I have to go ahead. Next one, I think two pages are there, no? Hello?
Pain sir, the next poll is now coming up.
Yeah.
Slide 54. I'm launching the poll now. Students, another poll here, another possible another 2.5 minutes for this poll, please. Another 30 seconds, students. In seconds more. Pinesap, I am ending the poll now.
Right. So in centrifugal pump, the efficiency increases with the ever increase of capacity. Efficiency increases with the ever increase of capacity. You can do any damn thing. No, we cannot do, my dear friends. That's why there is a efficiency is not a straight line curve. After certain point, it goes down. That's the point to take your in your mind. So it is false. You cannot take it to certain. You can take certain extent. That's why it is a curve. You know, on top. It is not a straight line. More head, more Q. More head, more Q. No. Okay. But at normally you think like that. It is not like that. After certain stage, you cannot do that. Reliability sensitivity curve provides an indication of efficient running of pump. This tolerance is approximately how much? Yes, 80 to 110% of BEP. Just now we discussed. Great. Great. So to enhance capacity, one should connect the pumps in series. Capacity enhancement in series. Capacity means flow. Flow should be always. Flow should be always in parallel connection. More flow, you need more pump in parallel. So to enhance capacity, this is one should connect the pumps in series is false. We need to have parallel. Speed regulation is always better option than flow control. Correct. You are right. In case of flow control by throttling, system curves become more steeper. Correct. It becoming going up like this, you know, more steeper. And it will reducing your efficiency, reducing H, Q, everything. It is damaging everything. So jitna marji बल्ब लगा दीजिए और हम जितना मर्जी 20% चलाएगा आप लिया 100% के लिए 30% में कंट्रोल भाव चल रहा है दुनिया डैमेज करेगा अनरिलायबिलिटी होगा आपको सिस्टम रेजिस्टेंस बढ़ जाएगा जरूर उससे अच्छा दूसरा पंप देखो और ट्राई टू थिंक समथिंग ऑन इंपेलर डायमीटर सो फॉर हाई फ्लो रिक्वायरमेंट पंप्स आर जनरली ऑपरेटेड इन पैरेलल ग्रेट You have written correctly here, but there you have done wrong way. Okay, so whatever. Great, thanks for responding. I think some input is going on in this regard. That's my point. Specific speed. Specific speed is index used to predict desired pump performance, general shape of pump's impeller. This is specific speed. We know anything specific, something on specificity, something specific, you know, to have a more reliable in our calculation. from something to have on our anything in specific, or ready to have a easier way of our understanding a subject, different parameters relationship. That is our specific register, heat, specific heat of pumps, turbines, everything specific things come. It is help us. And accordingly, standards are available on such and specific speak, what will be the impeller and impeller dia and all, and for application also. So it predicts general shape of the pump impeller. We'll come to know that why different shapes and specific speed takes care related. So equation below reads specific speed corresponding to geometrically. That means if geometrically similar pump, but not identical. You know, what can be the situation? Geometrically identical. Large, same impeller, smaller. Radius change kar diya. Geometry same. Tip velocity diagram will be same. Inlet velocity diagram of the fluid will be the same. Okay? Reduce kar diya diameter. So, different sizes. So, in that case, we need to have certain geometrically similar pumps. And that is a requirement in industry. Go more or less specific. And type of application wise. Application means always H and Q. So, how we select the pump. So, that way, specific speed is defined. Definition karne ke liye to aap padh lijiye na kya hai. Specific speed as defined as the speed of an ideal pump geometrically similar to the actual pump, which when running at the speed with the unit volume, unit K. And this whatever written here is given by this formula, you can see that. So, NS of a pump is calculated using BAP of the pump at full dia. Full dia, best efficiency point, what is the specific speed of the pump? And to know, after knowing this, we can select similar geometrical pump, but not identical, chota bada hoga, theek hai na? तो कैसे सिलेक्ट करेगा वो दिखने के लिए ए थॉट प्रोसेस स्पेसिफिक स्पीड इज हैज कम टू इनटू पिक्चर. सो एज ए कॉन्सेप्ट यू नो दिस, एज ए डेफिनेशन यू नो दिस, यू कैन रीड दिस. एंड इट इज अ फार्मूला डिपेंडिंग ऑन क्यू एंड क्यू टू द पावर हाफ डिवाइडेड बाय एच टू द पावर 3/4 इज द फार्मूला फॉर द स्पेसिफिक स्पीड. यू माइट हैव सीन इन योर फ्लूइड बुक्स एनीथिंग एंड गिवन व्हाट इज द स्पेसिफिक फ्लूइड ऑफ सर्टेन क्यू एंड सर्टेन एच गिवन लाइक दैट यू कैन कैलकुलेट द your exam purpose, all this. But this has got a specific speed, and accordingly, specific speed, once we change the impeller, select the impeller, so size also, and size months love, aapka HQ carb also change ho jayega. So direct impact also is effect on the shaft carb. This is a specific speed. Conceptually, it is dynamic similarity. मतलब हमको जियोमेट्रिकल एंगल बिटवीन इनपुट एंड आउटपुट ऑफ द ब्लेड इज नॉट गोइंग टू चेंज ऑन डिफरेंट सीरीज ऑफ द सेम सीरीज ऑफ पंप्स. आई थिंक आई एम एबल टू टेल यू ना. डायनामिक स्टेबिलिटी विल बी सेम बट आइडेंटिकल नहीं होगा. दैट इज द आइडिया. सो दिस इज अबाउट द स्पेसिफिक स्पीड. एंड अगेन यू कैन रीड दिस स्पेसिफिक स्पीड ऑफ ए पंप इज इंडिपेंडेंट ऑफ इट्स size. Why it is written? Size means bigger, lesser. Okay. Janna jaruri isliye hai to find out. Suppose this is also available in different standards. Suppose this is a 2,000 to 3,000 pumps. 2,000 and 3,000 specific pump Francis. Same specific. If you want to have a specific reduce the pump speed. And because of the speed, what is the specific speed? If you get 1,000, you can use this pump of similar geometry. Geometry are similar. Size is different. Can you see? That is all about. Okay. So suppose 900 GPa and 190 feet of head, 900 gallons per minute and feet of head. If these values are center, enter at Q and H in the equation of the specific speed, we get a specific speed of 3600 RPM. Enter in the equation of the pump speed, 3600 RPM, specific speed of the pump we get 2000 around. In that respect, we have to select this type of pumps. Geometrically similar, but not identical. So Francis Bain type of things we look to here. Then, so impeller size, impeller will be like that. Okay. Now if you select, too much admitting now and then and going as this big, big problem in my screen. So if speed is 1800 RPM, then speed, the speed is 1200 or so, then it's impeller design. Sorry, 1 minute. I mean, once you put this RPM, once you put a particular head and Q carb, you have got your requirement, you have got, and you get accordingly HQ carb, and you can get the similar. You want to have a change in opinion and you want to go to other machine, then specific speed will allow you which machine to apply, which is machine to select for. Okay, so this specific speeds given, this is all valid for single suction. Double suction will be different. Okay, so so you affect the HQ curve and provide prediction of impeller design, different type of impeller you can use it. And there is an impact on efficiency also. See, you can see efficiency curve here. For these pumps having 2,000 or 3,000 specific speed, having high efficiency, increasing over the time and higher efficiency, then lower specific speed pumps with efficiency, you can see there is a flat and much more broader, and quite good amount of capacity, almost flatter. Here, steeper. So around 2000 to 2000, accordingly, you have to select which pump. At the previous section, I have told you how Francis 2 you have to go to. Then, if you want to select lower specific speed, you have to select lower speed pump with geometrically similar pump of geometrically similar pump. You have to lower specific speed, you have to select. Higher is much more, say around 9000 or so. Suppose here, BEP at around BEP, best efficiency point is this, and this. Best efficiency point is flatter and broader, and the specific speed decreases. Specific speed decreases this side, so flatter and broader. Remember this specific speed. And low specific speed produce flat curves. High specific produce steep curve. You'll get steep like this. Okay, this is about specific peak curve. And you can see different curve with specific speed, radial flow, mixed flow, accordingly what type of flow will be there, accordingly. If you put axial flow, won't work here. So that's why axial flow, mixial flow, radial flow, this type of pumps will get this type of specific speed. And it is given. And this efficiency curve is stiffer here, flatter, much more flatter. Once you go in, this is all about this concept of specific speed has an impact on, you can see, has an impact on efficiency, has an impact on selecting of pump, means ultimate impeller. Okay. So pump system carbs, therefore, is earlier we are talking so much, is a static head and dynamic head combination. Plotting the pump carb and system carb would result in intersection point, which is called operating point. Operating point, you have to go all machine operating point, you have to run it. If you are going plus minus something, you are compromising the efficiency. You can go, people are going, and some places you have to go. Compromise this also. Okay. Understanding the concept, something else, but application sometimes different. Hard living in plants sometimes. You have to go more friction loss with the same pump, we have to run years together. People are doing it, can't help. But people are knowing. You have to take that, what is I'm losing here? How much energy I'm going losing? There is relationship between this loss. This is total loss. But we are putting same 75 kilowatt motor is running for that pump, suppose. There are pumps, 2 megawatt, 1 megawatt in 1.5 megawatt, 2 megawatt, and more than that in a refinery, petrochemical plant, you go to Jamnagar or any other place, you can see one simply fluid passing and so much kilowatt. This much loss is tremendous loss on electricity. Everything can be calculated nowadays. People are very smart in energy management now. And energy management people look here, they will kill us, maintenance guys and corporation guys. Why the hell you are putting these pumps here? Put it through the system garbage like this, change this pump, or go send it for impeller streaming. Like these things going on in the practical field. So this is all about the same thing discussed here. I'm not going much on this. That's what system head curve. At the point, this is system head. If system is static, is no head. This can start from here directly. You're pumping, and whatever the pumping in between loss is loss. It is a frictional head loss, dynamic head loss. But if it is static head itself, you have to put it some higher in crude oil. In other places, so much high distance, you have to put some your pump has to lift. You know, different distillation coulomb, you have to put the pump, heat exchangers, put in such and such a place, always not in the ground. So things are happening in the practical pit, system head has to be encountered. And if you have not taken consideration in project, this is taken care by all project people, combining a team of mechanical, fluid, mechanical, electrical, as well as chemical, and instrumentation. Because exactly pump carb, HQ carb should be head loss. And flow, everything to be properly digitally transferred to your screen. Okay. And accordingly, it is to be controlled from there also. That it has to be increased. Nowadays, nobody is going to the pump to control the pump valve. Okay. All valve, butterfly, or kuch bhi ho. All valves are controlled by instruments. Our instrumentation guys here, friends, colleagues, they are expert on this. They know what is going on in the control valve. Instrumentation now in petrochemical, chemical means. Completely this system, this study has gone to the instrumentation department, you know. In some places, I will find, hey, this is into the instrumentation level. Why the hell this car, mechanical items are lying here? All the valves are lying there. They're all so much electronically, digitally monitored and controlled. Okay, that is another part. So, in shift of system curve with throttling, I have already explained, but this is an explanation in terms of a figure. So, 500 flow, and 50 meter head. Can I see how many slides are left? Accordingly, I can bother you, or there is just a minute. Shall I continue 10, 15 minutes? Madam.
Yes, no. Sir. Yes, sir. You can.
Okay, great. Okay. If any of our colleagues want to leave, may leave just 10, 15 minutes. Okay. Yeah, because I have things I put up for the students, I even just to convey a message. So 500 cubic meter, 50 meter head. So 300 cubic meter is we want to go. We want to be sufficient. This is the pump you have purchased, but we are sufficient to 300. What is going to do? We have to get a revised point, revised parameter, 300 to 70. So we have to go down to this. You can see at sea head is 42. So this much head you have to encounter to go to this efficiency, keeping this efficiency, this. Or if you don't want to keep efficiency, okay, you have to increase the power so that we get the efficiency curve here. So that our flow 300, efficiency little less. So that is the given here. To install a new pump, choice will be either install a new pump to be at BEP at sea, install a new pump, where you can get this carb, new carb, blue carb, okay? Or same pump, or there are many other options, reduce the speed impeller, or same pump, waiting room, 1 minute, I'm not able to see in my screen the last one. Blue pump carb will represent either of these two options, okay? Either of these options. So these options will be available. This is a new pump where you can go for the C, for 300 cubic meter per head, but your head will be only 42. Okay, if you want to take more head, and you have to, for the same cubic meter, then you have to lose the efficiency. This is all about shifting of system curve. Okay, throttling means you are making resistant to the flow, na? सिंपल मेकिंग रेजिस्टेंस टू फ्लूइड थ्रॉटलिंग क्लोज कर रहे हैं ना उसको सिस्टम का डायनेमिक प्रॉब्लम लेके आ रहा है उसके सो दैट इज ऑल अबाउट द graphical explanation and clear explanation you can get it to any books anywhere this is a clear explanation you can little bit you can go and sometimes so a flow rate curve in head in case of displacement curve head decreases over the time that's why it is good for low flow region high head low flow region. Centrifugal pump centrifugal pump it is always give this type of HQ curve with the flow increase there is a head decrease but we can have a justified point so if you have a system of this problem of this to be encountered by flowing system of this you can think which pump I'll use reciprocating then you will have less flow with this head if you have see centrifugal pump then you have this head both way you can go out of the system problems you can go out of the system problem either way now you have to think which one I will select As a student, you should understand that, okay. And you apply whenever you get job in industry or you do research anywhere, okay. Or any marketing. Suppose you are in marketing, you have to explain to maintenance engineer, chemical engineer like this, not less lot. You have to be explain like this. People are not. Sir, इतना flow देता है, इतना है, अच्छा bearing लगाया, मेरा pump बहुत no no. They are not going to listen. These are layman's talk. So people will think this way. They will take. Let us come to the table. I'll explain. The chemical engineer take you on toes. So pump efficiency is a hydraulic efficiency which comes total head into flow into row. Pump के लिए water के लिए 1000 है G. Okay. Row G 9.8 divided by 1000 kilowatt करने के लिए 1000. So it in kilowatt total head hydraulic power. Hydraulic power, shaft power is whatever hydraulic is given is not whatever shaft is providing to the pump. Every energy is not going to the fluid. Okay, there is some lacuna. There is some loss. That loss is taken by pump efficiency, which so pump efficiency therefore is pump efficiency therefore hydraulic power divided by shaft power. Shaft power is always more. Okay, electrical input again whatever put electrical in is pump is not giving. Pump has got own problem. Electrical input. Pump shaft में जो मिला है pump को उतना electrical से कम है. So there is another efficiency involved here. So motor efficiency. So motor efficiency is also there is motor problems. Motor maybe eccentric air gap. Maybe electrical unbalance. Maybe true unbalance even mechanical. There is so many loss in the motor. We will discuss in different forum all those things. In vibration or some other balancing class. So pump efficiency, understanding this curve, with this efficiency, suppose at point E, efficiency 60%, best efficiency point E, this is the efficiency 60%. These are all five efficiency, head HQ curve, pump performance curve. We want to understand this problem 68 cubic meter per hour of water at 47 meter head okay 47 meter head this is the 68 cubic meter per hour we need 68 cubic meter of per hour flow pump characteristics for a range of pumps are given in this figure at point E the efficiency is 60% can you see efficiency this is the efficiency iso efficiency graph this is the one graph 60 this is another graph next one this is 55 next one this is 50 again so this is graph is like this so in hydraulic power is 68 is the q is here 68 hour cubic meter per hour okay per second karna padega na formula mein so total head 47 is the meter this is the meter 47 head and 1000 row and 9.8 is the g so we get 8.7 kilowatt is the g shaft power You have to put now mechanical efficiency of the pump. So mechanical efficiency, see pump efficiency, pump efficiency now is put 60%. Say 60% is the efficiency of this. So in that you have to again divide this with this shaft to get the shaft power. This is the flow actual. So hydraulic actual. So actual flow whatever you are getting. by losing something, that means HEP power has to be more than that. So 8.7 divided by 60 of this pump efficiency, and again divided by 90%, taking motor efficiency 90%, we get 16 kilowatt. So 60% efficiency, motor power is 16 kilowatt. And when you can take 50% efficiency, similar way, if you calculate, we get less power. So 50%, if you take 50% efficiency, okay, at 50% efficiency, your motor 50% efficiency, you get, so divided by 50%, see 28, and motor power required is 31. 31 is the motor power is more. More power at less efficiency. Matlab, you're encountering loss now. So much loss. Loss in power, loss in flow. So there are 31. That means additional power, you are putting into 15 kilowatt almost. So by going from 60% to 50%, additional power you are putting 15 kilowatt. And pura saal ke liye kitna hoga? My God. 5 lakhs per one for one pump. In refinery, thousands of pumps. Thousands. Such a big refinery. So small, bigger, different design. You understand energy is such a big issue. And why efficiency of the pump taken so carefully? 58% industry. Okay. So that is the things why people are so happy by doing that. So affinity laws. Just a minute, I will take. There is affinity laws. Yes. Okay, I'll finish affinity law. Few questions and leave within 10 minutes. Okay, so affinity laws are related to the RPM. Okay, so it looks like this. Q is proportional to N. Head proportional to N square and power is proportional to Q. That means, agar aap speed double karenge, to flow bhi double hoga. Speed double karenge, to flow pressure 4 times hoga. Speed double karenge, to power 8 times ho jayega. This is the affinity law. It's law, the relationship between dynamic pumps and the performance parameter is the affinity law. Affinity to these parameters. Affinity is what? Affinity to these parameters. So that's why I call it the affinity law. Affinity derived from this dimensional analysis of three important parameters is the affinity law. Sorry. Can you see now? Yeah. Hello, Anand. Hello.
Well, yes, sir, we can see.
You can hear me properly?
Yes, we can hear you. Affinity law is screen chal raha.
Okay. Affinity dimensional analysis of three. It is a dimensional analysis of three important parameters. It has got impact of diameter also. Diameters ke saath directly proportional to D, directly proportional, flow is proportional directly to the D, head is proportional square, and power is proportional to the Q. So affinity laws can be used to predict the performance of the pump at different diameters of the same speed or different speed for the same diameter. Okay, previously you have seen different speed for the same diameter, and this is the different diameter, same speed, keeping same speed, you get same formula, another formula, keeping diameter is the constant, two types of you get. So by decreasing or increasing diameter, you can go up to 10 to 20%. I already told you, you cannot go more than that. So this affinity law, suppose D is increased. So accordingly, proportional Q increase. D double, so head will be 4 times and it will be 8 times in case of power. So that is all about affinity laws. I don't want to go much on this. Now in case of trimming the impeller, you get like this. The pump originally served this and after trimming it served this. So you have a compromise on the head and quality, a head and capacity. So desired flow is this. Previous desired flow was this. So accordingly, impeller trimming you have to do. Okay. So with this, impeller trimming reduces tip speed. Tip speed reduces, but specific speed also reduces. You have seen earlier. Affinity law described for pump theoretical relationship between impeller size and pump output. Okay, assuming constant speed at same speed. So impeller speed through conservative design practices, these are the things done generally in impeller trimming is done more frequently. So these are the laws of affinity laws, and these affinity laws is very useful on in trimming cost, trimming effect, because you know the relationship accordingly, you can find out. All in a nutshell, same thing is given here. So once you do a study, suppose you want to do model, whether it will work in the physical part or not. So affinity laws will take care of it. Okay, specific speed will see the pump size, how it is going, higher size, lower size, and how these things are happening. So that way. Now here in affinity laws, some example, flow rate. Suppose flow rate, head and power of centrifugal pump increased, has increased its speed. Find the flow rate, head and power, all three, for a centrifugal pump that has increased its speed. Speed increase ho gaya, 1000 se jyada ho gaya. Toh kya hoga? Sir, 1000 se 1100 ho gaya, toh, see, Q2 will be different. Okay, suppose 1000 se 1100 ho gaya, toh, head will be around 121, jo 123 tha, sorry, 100 meter tha, वो 121 मीटर हो गया, ओके, बाय इंक्रीजिंग द स्पीड. नाउ बाय इंक्रीजिंग द स्पीड, पावर रिक्वायरमेंट, जो पावर रिक्वायरमेंट 123 था, पावर रिक्वायरमेंट और बढ़ गया, 8 टाइम्स बढ़ गया. कैन यू सी दिस पॉइंट, 1.1 टाइम होल्ड टू द पावर 3 मल्टीप्लाइड बाय अदर्स, यू कैन गेट दिस. सो एफिनिटी, योर सिंपल एग्जांपल इज दिस. नाउ यू कैन नॉट, यू नीड नॉट टू डू, वंस यू लर्न दिस कांसेप्ट, यू हैव अ सॉफ्टवेयर्स different company gives. Once you put pressure, flow, speed, your operating condition down, now you adjusting, you want to adjust. What type of adjustment you can do? Put the things, speed kam karna chahta hai, zyada karna chahta hai, to accordingly aapko efficiency theek hai, kitna kam ho raha hai, accordingly aap de sakta hai. And specific gravity ke to karna hai nahi hai yahan pe, because you are not considering centrifugal pumps gravity much, only in the supporting pump. So this is all about these things, same curve is reflected now and then, here and there, to understand, to keep everything. Let us recap session before finishing it off. We'll take 5 minutes and we'll finish it. Finish this.
So, Pine sir, I have launched the next poll.
Yeah.
Students, I have launched the next poll. Can you please start looking at it and responding as you see the answers there? Keep it on for about a minute and a half.
Okay, you can go ahead, stop polling.
Another 10 minutes, 10 seconds maybe. Pins up.
Okay.
The students are still responding. I just give them another 10 seconds. Yeah, Pine sir, I am ending the poll now.
Okay, so system come very right. Most of the people have responded correctly. It is all resistance. Okay, pump efficiency get reduced during throttling. Correct. True. Yes, because you are increasing the resistance. Engineer wishes to evaluate the second pump of same OEM, of same series, known performance, but different in size. He or she needs to refer what? Engineer wishes to evaluate a second pump of same OEM, same series ke pump, same MM, but different in size. Okay, so specific speed data. Okay, only one. Specific speed data. Specific known performance, but different in size. You should need to repair. See, other things you always need to know. But thing is that same OEM, if you have a series of pump, I want to change in the same, this impeller has to go to in the same casing. Okay, so in that case, whether I have formulated the question rightly or not, but idea is second pump of the same series, I want to put it. So it goes to specific data, simple, no other calculation required. All velocity, other damp, nothing to see. You once you see the specific, you'll just simply switch to Francis impeller to or radial impeller. Which type of impeller he will put? Immediately he will put and then put the sides, no problem. Different side. It is dynamic stability, dynamic integrity is there, but in equal, but identical is not. They're not identical. Then size, different size. So that means it needs to be specific speed. Head cap all will have. Head cap and speed data, to sab kahi rehta hai. Speed data is not a big issue. Okay, speed data is rehta hi rehta hai. As the specific it decreases, the area around BEP becomes flatter. Yes, very right. Very right. Area around BEP increases. That's the importance of specific speed. Flatter means lower speed zone. Okay. Okay, so equation relating dynamic performance parameter of flow are known as equation relating dynamic affinities law. Correct. Very nice. Then what is the impact of flow and pressure when the impeller of pump is trimmed? Impeller of pump is trimmed. Reduce. Impeller. What is the impact of flow and pressure when the impeller of a pump is trimmed? That means both flow and pressure trim. Both are flow decreases, correct? Decreases is the correct because your impeller impact on flow when the impeller of pump is trim, aap impeller chota kar raha hai, theek hai? To aapko pressure and flow both kam hote jayega, theek hai? Reduces, okay, okay. So with this, I think I have come to the end of this today's session. What is this? 1 minute. I think in last question YouTube could not see because I could not click that one. So with this, another. Okay, another Anand.
Yeah. The last poll for the day.
Oh my God.
Vainsab, it just doesn't have too many questions. Just a few of them, students. And in the meanwhile, I think Professor Sheetal Patel, would you like to post the feedback form for the students to start responding also? Vainsab, any other closing remarks from your side?
Tomorrow class will have a capitation and PCH. And main thing is what is the impact of support, unbalance, and you know, all these things to the pump. And tomorrow we'll have a session on maintenance of the pumps.
Wow.
Maintenance of the different important maintenance. Okay, so let us end polling now.
So we can end the polling now, and just we can read the results. I'm sharing the results on the screen.
Okay, now. For large capacity centrifugal pump design efficiency are in the range of 85%, correct? Okay. In the speed of centrifugal pump is double its power consumption by how many times? Almost 8 times, correct? Okay. 8 times power consumption. You have seen power consumption when the centrifugal pump speed with power. Okay. You have seen the affinity law. You can see it is in cube. So the speed is increasing, doubling, so 2 to the power cube ho jata hai na, so 8 times. So that means 8 times. Actually, I put in 8 times, 4 times like this question, but because it is in poll, so that's why it is not covered here. In who are in the YouTube, they can see. In case of centrifugal pumps, impeller dia changes are generally limited to reducing the diameter to about 50 to 60%, no, 75%, 80%, 50-60% kore to pura fir pump hi naya le lijiye na, uska aadha nikal hi diya na diameter, to kya fayda hai? It is just last minute option. We cannot change the impeller now and then. Aap pura impeller ko 50% karega to matlab hi nahi hai na, 50-60%. So either you go for new pump or you trim the 10-20%, I have told number of times, or 75-80% of the total maximum size, or 10%, 10-20% of this maximum size down, reducing that much. So that is the idea. Delivery valve of the pump is throttled to deliver 30% of the rated flow. One of the best option for improved energy efficiency will be all. Replacing, so trimming of the impeller, replacing the motor, replacing the impeller with a smaller size diameter, any of the option you can take it. Either replace motor, or shift suitable, make easy, or replace the motor, or trim the impeller, or replace the impeller with a smaller size impeller, whatever you can do. So it's good, any of the three you can do it. Okay, delivery valve of the pump is throttled 30% of the rated flow. One of the best option for improved energy efficiency would be, I think I put somewhere all of the above or so in the question. Yeah. Okay. What is that? I put this due one. Okay, trimming of the flow we discussed also a few minutes back. Correct. So that is the correct option. Okay, so system car is basically a resistance curve and can be overcome in the physical configuration. Yes, true. Yes, changes with the physical configuration. Very right, correct. So what option would be available if the flow from a centrifugal pump is to be reduced? Here, I think all the three options are correct for centrifugal pump. What options are available if the flow from a centrifugal pump is to be reduced? All the options are correct. Better option, that one 30% I told you impeller, but all options are correct. So with this sim, some understanding of your thought process on pump, we'll have an understanding. This is operation, how it is, what are the operation complexity, any way you cannot put the head and capacity or impeller or number of impeller. It has got scientific tools behind it, and we have to understand that. We have to understand the performance curves. We have to understand the system curves behind. We have to understand the specific speed. We have to understand the affinity laws and these laws, and understand the Bernoulli's equation to how pump is not cavitating. To understand all these things, you have to have already you are studying in the syllabus also. So with this, I finish today, and tomorrow we'll start with some maintenance important tips on maintenance of the pumps. Okay, with latest maintenance tips, techniques available also, whatever I time I get. Sorry for the delay, because I think I have to see tomorrow timing accordingly. Thank you for your patient hearing, and thank you very much.
Yeah, thanks a lot, Pain sir. If you can stop sharing your presentation, let me call back Professor Sheetal Patel for any closing remarks for the day. Sheetal ma'am, if you're there.
Yes, sir. Yeah, I'm there. Hello. Yeah.
Yeah.
On behalf of Department of Mechanical Engineering, Bhartiya Vidyapeeth, and also along with the Chemical Department, I just want to extend my thanks to Dr. Poen for sharing his, I can say, knowledge, deep knowledge on pump. Thank you so much. I hope students must got a takeaway, enough takeaway from today's session, and might have made their fundamental very strong on the pump. Right, because I'm getting so many comments on your pump that it's a wonderful session. So I must extend a thanks to Mr. Iyer also for arranging such a wonderful session. Thank you very much, sir.
Thanks a lot, ma'am, for that. And it's been a pleasure that all the students did stay back, even though it got extended by almost 50 minutes. So yes, students do connect tomorrow at the same time. And as I was mentioning on the post, if you have got any questions that would be there from today's session, please pass them on to Professor Patel. We will consolidate all the questions and put it across to Dr. Payne for him to respond back tomorrow.
Sure, definitely.
And I hope that you all are able to access the feedback link which has been shared by Professor Patel. And please continue to complete your feedbacks and get in touch with Professor Patel for any further clarifications or query. Thanks a lot, Payne sir, for this wonderful session.
Ananta, thank you, Dr. Payne.
Ananta, there is also a request from the YouTube regarding registrations. A lot of messages about mails having gone out from BBCOE, and they would like to get in touch for links and things like that. A lot of feedback on YouTube too.
Yes, so, sir. Definitely, we are going to reopen the registration form once again, so that those who have missed it out, they can again register themselves.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you so much.
Thanks a lot. Okay. Thanks a lot, Sam, for bringing that up.
We will be waiting for Dr. Payne tomorrow.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Thanks a lot.
Thank you. Have a good time. I'm closing the call now.